Thank you. Okay. Dobro jutro svima. Jako vas je lepo vidjeti sve ovdje. Volim što ste nasmejani, volim što ste se uželili jedni drugih i što pričate jedni sa drugima. Slava Bogu za to. Ali sada bih vas pozvala sedeći da otpevamo dve pesme na početku, a onda posle ćemo krenuti sa programom. Znači, sedeći otpevat ćemo dve pesme. For all of you who didn't understand me, we're gonna sing two songs, sitting, and after that we'll continue with our program.
Oh, prosti grehe moje. Dobro jutro i subotni blagoslov svima.
Good morning and happy Sabbath to everyone.
Jako se radujem što danas mogu vidjeti puno dragih lica i upoznati neka nova.
I'm very pleased to be able to see many familiar faces and also to get to know some new faces.
Ovo je veliki dan i ovaj poseban sabor za sve nas. Volio bih da otpočnem sa psalmom 150.
This special day, I would like to start with Psalm 150. Psalm 150. Oh, good.
Okay. Hvalite Boga u svetinji njegovoj, hvalite ga na tvrđi slave njegove.
Praise ye the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power.
Hvalite ga prema sili njegovoj, hvalite ga prema visokom veličanstvu njegovom.
Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness.
Hvalite ga uz glas trubni, hvalite ga uz psaltir i gusle.
Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp.
Hvalite ga sa bubnjem i veseljem, hvalite ga uz žice i organ.
Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs.
Hvalite ga uz jasne kimvale, hvalite ga uz kimvale gromovne.
Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals.
Sve što diše, neka hvali Boga.
Let everything that had breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Aleluja.
Amen.
Kada pogledamo nebo danju ili nebo noću,
when we look at the sky either at night or the sky during the day,
kada pogledamo okean,
when I look at the ocean,
čak i kada odemo u mikrosvet i pogledamo te male stvari,
when I go into the micro world and see the tiny little things,
kada pogledamo cvetnu baštu ili prelepu šumu,
when we look at the beautiful flower in the garden or the beautiful forest,
kada smo okruženi tim divnim stvarima, naše srce je pozvano da kaže hvalim te Gospode.
When we are surrounded by these beautiful things, our heart is prone to say, thank you Lord, I praise you Lord.
Iako je Bog nevidljiv za naše oči, ne možemo da ga vidimo.
Even though God is unseen to us, we cannot see him.
I te kako možemo da ga vidimo kroz dela njegovog stvaranja.
We can very much see him through the works of his hands.
A zato što smo okruženi njegovom dobrotom sa svih strana, pokrenuti smo iznutra da ga slavimo.
And because we are surrounded by his love around all of us, we are turned to praise him.
I sve što bliže budemo prilazili Bogu, sve jača želja postaje da ga slavimo.
And the closer we come to God, the more our desire becomes to praise him.
Kao što je pesma kazala, slaviti spasa kroz celi dan.
As the song said, praising my Savior all the day through.
Želim sve da vas pozdravim na ovom saboru.
I would like to welcome you all to this gathering today.
Sve vas koji dolazite iz bilo kog kraja Australije.
All of you who are coming from the many parts of Australia today.
A jutros čujemo da ima gostiju iz Japana, iz ostalih krajeva, iz Evrope.
This morning we heard there are guests from Japan, from other parts of the world, from Europe.
Da li ima još neki kontinent da je zastupljen?
Is there another continent that hasn't been mentioned?
Afrika.
Africa.
Pozdravljamo.
Welcome.
Za našu crkvu Sedan ovo je jako bitan dan.
For our Sedan Church, this is a very important day.
Razgovarajući sa nekim pre godinu dana ovde u crkvi,
talking to someone about a year ago at church here,
rekli su mi, pre 2-3 godine smo imali 50 godina crkve.
They said to me, 2 or 3 years ago we had the 50th anniversary of the Sedan Church.
Oh ne, to je bilo pre 9 godina, ja sam ih ispravio.
Oh, actually, that was 9 years ago, I said to them.
Oh, kako vreme leti.
How time flies.
Znate šta je žalosno? Što ima puno praznih mesta onih koji su bili prošli put tu, a više nisu tu.
You know what is sad? That many of those who were with us last time are no longer here with us today.
I ne znamo ko će od nas biti tu kad se bude slavila 70. godina.
We don't know who of us will be here if we have a 70th anniversary.
Da Bog da slavimo gore na nebu.
May the Lord grant us to be up there to celebrate.
Kada su naši prvi doseljenici došli na ove krajeve,
when our first settlers came to these parts,
uključili su se i bili su prihvaćeni u sestrinstvo crkava Viktorijske konferencije.
They immersed themselves and were adopted into the sisterhood of this Adventist church in conference here.
Sve to bilo sa ciljem da zajedno s ovim narodom bolje objavimo Hristov dolazak.
That was all with the goal that together we all proclaim the coming of Christ.
Danas bih želeo da počnemo sa jednim pitanjem.
Today I would like us to start with one question.
Pitanje glasi ovako.
The question is this.
Da li smo mi danas željni i motivisani da objavimo vest isto tako kao oni u početku?
Are we as motivated today to make sure that the good news of salvation goes out to all as those of our pioneers who arrived many years ago?
Ima li vatre u tvom srcu da objaviš vest više nego što su to radili oni koji su pokrenuli ovu crkvu?
Is there fire in your heart to be able to move and spread the gospel more than it was in the beginning?
Mnogi koji su gradili ovu crkvu su zaspali u Gospodu.
Many of those who have built this church have fallen asleep in the Lord.
Ali su imali snagu i volju.
But they had strength and the will.
Danas dok budemo prolazili kroz različite iskaze ljudi koji će nam pričati o tom vremenu.
Today as we go through the various stories of the people who talk about that time.
Naša želja nije da njih veličamo koji su to gradili.
Our wish is not to uplift those that have built this church.
Iako jako cenimo taj trud.
Even though we appreciate it very much.
Želim da uđemo u njihova srca i da vidimo odakle dolazila ta motivacija i tolika želja.
We would like to try to have a peek into their heart to see where that motivation and that will came for them.
Iako je moguće da tu motivaciju i tu želju danas uživimo.
And also to see if we can garnish this motivation for us today.
Iskreno se nadam da ćemo njihovim iskazima i videima koje ćemo pogledati biti ohrabreni.
I am sure that we will be encouraged by the stories and the videos that we will see today.
Kad se završi ovaj naš sabor, da možemo da kažemo da smo sreli Gospoda.
When this gathering is finished, that we can say that we met the Lord.
Da smo ga slavili sa svim instrumentima koje smo imali.
That we praised him with all the instruments that we had.
Sa svim raspoloživim sredstvima koje imamo.
With all the means that we have.
Svime onom što imamo i onim što jesmo.
With everything that we have and that we are.
Sada bih pozvao naš worship team da nas povede u jednoj pesmi.
We'd like to call the worship team up to sing.
Sve bih vas pozvao da na zvuke instrumenata ustanemo i otpevamo pesmu broj 14.
If you can stand after the introduction and we'll sing hymn number
14. Pesma Kad gledam ja, nebesa tvoja Bože.
Then sings my soul.
Nakon pesme sa nama će molitvu na kolenima uputiti sestra Lidija Božinovska.
I ask those of you who can to kneel, and the rest you can remain standing. How great thou art. Father God, we praise you for this privilege that we are here today. Like the pastor said, help us to truly praise your name with everything we have and everything we are. Bless every soul that is here today, those that are watching that are not able to come, those that will watch in the future days to come. Lord, use us all in the last days, Lord. Use us so we may praise your name, so we may spread the gospel, so Jesus may come soon, so we can all go home. That is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Boži blagoslov, braće i sestre i prijatelji i sa moje strane.
Happy Sabbath and God's blessings, friends, brothers and sisters from me as well.
Danas sam video lica koja dugo nisam video.
This morning I have seen faces that I haven't seen for a very long time.
I danas vidim lica koja prvi put vidim u životu.
And today I'm seeing some faces that I'm seeing for the first time in my life.
I otprilike ovo je kao neki uvod ili kako da ga nazovemo, nešto kako će izgledati na novoj zemlji.
And maybe this is just a taste of how it will be on the new earth.
Možete li zamisliti samo na novoj zemlji kad se budemo sreli i još upoznamo još mnoga nova lica koja su tamo?
Can you just imagine on the new earth and in heaven when we meet many faces that we know and many new faces that we will meet that day?
Tako da ovaj današnji skup neka bude neka, kako da je nazovemo, predslika, dobro si rekao, predslika onoga što će možda biti.
May this meeting today, our gathering, be just a tiny vision and a tiny taste of what it would be like in heaven.
Danas je, kao što znate, 60-godišnjica crkve.
As you know, today is our 60th anniversary of the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Sedan.
Ali danas je i kraj jednog tromesečja.
But today is also the end of a quarter.
Kraj jedne godine još malo.
The end of almost one year.
I kada je kraj tromesečja, kad je u pitanju naša biblijska pouka, mi imamo jedan rezime cele pouke.
And at the end of the quarter, we usually have a short summary of our quarterly lesson, Sabbath school lesson.
Tako da ćemo mi sada u narednih nekoliko minuta imati, obnovit ćemo ono što smo proučavali celo tromesečje.
So in the next few minutes, we will cover through what we studied in the last 12 weeks, the last 3 months.
A kroz biblijsku pouku vodit će nas naša sestra Bosiljka Lipković.
And Sister Bosiljka Lipković will lead us through the lesson. She happens to be my mom. Thank you.
Dobro jutro, subotnoškolski razred.
Good morning, Sabbath school class.
Brat Siniša kaže da nije mnoga lica vidio ili prepoznao.
Brother Siniša is saying that he hasn't seen many faces and some he couldn't recognize.
58 godina unazad stupila sam prvi puta u ovu divnu crkvu.
58 years ago I stepped into this church for the first time.
I mnoga divna lica su još uvijek tu.
And many beautiful faces are still here.
Istina, promijenili smo se.
We have changed a little bit.
I mraz je pao.
And the dew and the snow has fallen.
Ali tu smo Božjom milošću.
But we're here by the grace of God.
Smatram ovo prednošću i odgovornošću da otvorim s vama Božju riječ.
I count it as a privilege and a responsibility to open the word of God with you.
Što je svrha subotne škole?
What is the point, the object of Sabbath school?
Škola. School. Kad se spomene škola,
when you mention school,
znači nešto učimo,
we're learning,
što nismo znali i što treba da znamo.
That we haven't known and that we need to know.
U ovom slučaju svakako to je Božja riječ, to je najbolja škola.
In this instance, it is the word of God, which is the best school.
Jer kroz proučavanje raste naša vjera.
Because through study, our faith grows.
Ja sam ovih dana pripremajući se uzela biblijsku pouku.
These last few days, as I was preparing, I took the Sabbath school quarterly.
I počela sam brojati glavne stihove.
And I started counting the main verses.
Ne sve stihove, samo glavne.
Not all the texts, just the main texts.
U ovom jednom tromjeseću ja sam nabrojala 71.
In this one quarter I counted 71.
Glavni stih što nam je dano za proučavanje.
Major texts that have been given to us to study.
Mnoga mjesta su sadržavala dva ili nekoliko stihova.
Many places gave us two or more texts.
Ali recimo neka bude dva.
But let's say two.
Ako 70 pomnožimo sa dva,
if we multiply 70 times 2,
dobijemo svakako 140.
We get 140.
Ne računajući stihove koji se nalaze u primjedbama.
Not counting the texts that are found in the comment section.
Te nisam brojala jer bi se izgubila.
I didn't
bez
count
kalkulatora.
Those because I would have gotten a bit lost. There's so many.
Ali ako uzmemo te najglavnije stihove,
if we take these major texts,
i pomnožimo ih sa četiri tromjesečja,
and we multiply them by the four quarters of the year,
četiri puta 140,
four times 140,
560 glavnih stihova u jednoj godini,
560 major texts in one year,
što nam je onda Isus rekao, od čega čovjek živi?
So what did Jesus say and what did he exactly mean by man shall not live?
Man shall not, da, čovjek ne živi od svakoj okruhu.
Man shall not live by bread alone.
Nego o svakoj riječi koja izlazi iz usta Božih.
But by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
560 glavnih stihova nam je dano u godini dana.
560 major verses have been given to us in one year.
Onda sam pomislila na Psalam 23.
Then I thought about Psalm 23.
Postavio si preda mnom trpezu ili stol.
You set before me a table.
I čaša je moja prepuna.
And my cup runneth over.
Naš duhovni stol koji nam Gospod je ispunio je prepun.
Our spiritual table that the Lord has set before us is overfilling.
Što da čovjek kaže?
What can we say?
Na Božju dobrotu i milost i slobodu koju nam daje da još uvijek možemo otvoriti Božju riječ.
For the goodness and the mercy of God and for the freedom that we can still open the word of God.
I pored ovog velikog izobilja na našem duhovnom stolu,
and despite this great bounty on our spiritual table,
mi se nalazimo na nekoj duhovnoj dijeti.
We find ourselves on some kind of spiritual diet.
Mogu početi od sebe.
I can start with myself.
Upravo kao da nekako bolujemo od neke duhovne anoreksije.
It seems to be that we are suffering from some kind of spiritual anorexia.
Skoro da smo na samrti duhovnoj.
We're almost on the deathbed spiritually.
Imamo 13 stihova koje treba da zapamtimo, znači da naučimo na pamet.
That we have 13 texts that we should be learning off by heart.
Neću pitati da dignete ruke.
I won't ask you to put your hands up.
Da vas upitam jeste li ih naučili na pamet.
To ask you if you did learn them off by heart.
Jer i sama bi bila kriva za to.
Because I would be guilty as well.
Ovako, da li se slažete sa ovom dijagnozom?
Do you agree with this diagnosis, brothers and sisters?
Mislim, općenito govorimo.
We're talking as a whole.
Što onda da radimo?
What shall we do then?
Da nastavimo istim tempom ili nešto se mora desiti?
To continue in the same tempo or does something need to change up?
Pokajanje.
Repentance.
Priznanje i vapaj za pomoć.
Acknowledgement and a plea for help.
Ja osjećam da treba da viknemo, Gospode, pomagaj, spašavaj, izbavljaj.
I feel that we need to shout out, Lord, help us, deliver us.
Psalm 85, 6. stih.
Psalm 85, verse 6.
Psalm 85, 6. stih.
Psalm 85, verse 6.
Zar se nećeš povratiti i oživjeti nas?
Wilt thou not revive us again?
Da bi se narod tvoj radovao o tebi.
That thy people may rejoice in thee.
Znači, Gospod je taj koji nas može oživjeti.
So the reality is that the God, the Lord, is the one that can bring us to life.
Ali mi moramo to tražiti.
But we have to ask.
Duhovnu resuscitaciju.
Spiritual resuscitation.
Prihvatimo savjet vjernoga svjedoka.
Let's take the advice of the faithful witness.
Šta nam je Gospod rekao da kupimo od njega?
What did the Lord ask us to buy from him?
Jer je dijagnozirao našu situaciju jako kritičnu.
Because he diagnosed our situation as very critical.
Otkrivenje 3:15.
Revelation 3:15.
To znamo i na pamet, ali ćemo ipak pročitati.
We know it off by heart, but we will read it.
Znam tvoja djela, da nisi ni studen ni vruć. O, da si studen i vruć.
I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would thou wert cold or hot.
Yeah. Prema tome on kaže, savjetujem te da kupiš od mene.
So he advises us to buy from him
sve ono što nama treba u ovoj situaciji.
Everything that we need in this situation.
Rješenje je tu.
The solution is here.
Da li je dobra volja naša tu?
Do we have the good will?
Da li je poniznost tu?
Is humbleness here?
Da li je svjesnost da smo ovisni o njemu?
Is there an awareness that we are dependent on God?
Jer jedino on može oživjeti.
Because the only he can revive us.
I može nas promijeniti.
And can change us.
A promjena je potrebna, jer ne možemo nastaviti tapkanje na istome mjestu.
And change is vital because we cannot stand in one place.
Mi ćemo sada ponoviti svih 13 stihova.
We're just going to go through the 13 verses for this quarter.
Sjećam se naše sedonske djece.
I remember our children in Sedon, our youth.
Kad su svake 13. subote ovdje stajali,
when every 13th Sabbath they would stand here,
i svako od njih je znao na pamet 13 stihova iz subotne škole.
And every single one of them knew the 13 Sabbath school verses off by heart.
I to je bilo nešto što se ne može zaboraviti.
And that's something that
mnoge
we don't
majke
forget.
Klimaju glavom.
Many
i
mothers
potvrđuju.
Are nodding their heads. Yes. Yes.
I ovo dijete je također petak na večer, mama, daj da izrecitiram ponovo, da budem sigurna da ću sutra znati.
And this kid had a go as well, knowing the verses, yes.
Da. Mm. Izvinite. Počet ćemo od prve biblijske pouke, zlatni stih, i koji nam kaže tekst za pamćenje.
We'll start with our first lesson, and the text is for remembrance.
A Gospod Bog viknu Adama i reče mu, gdje si?
Then the Lord God called Adam and said to him, where are you?
Bog traži, jer Božja misija i naša misija idu zajedno.
God is seeking because God's mission and our mission go together.
On je prvi inicijator.
He is the initiator.
Sljedeći zlatni stih koji smo trebali naučiti, možda neki jesu, jeste iz druge biblijske pouke.
The lesson number two, our memory text.
Idite dakle i naučite sve narode, krsteći ih u ime Oca i Sina i Svetoga Duha.
Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Isto to, isti nalog i važi i danas. This, do kraja.
This same call is made for us today.
Da bi to bilo ispunjeno, on nam kaže u trećoj biblijskoj pouci kako će se to desiti.
For this to be fulfilled, the Lord tells us in lesson 3 how it will happen.
Nego ćete primiti silu Duha Svetoga kad siđe na vas i bit ćete mi svjedoci Jeruzalemu, Judeji, Samariji i do kraja zemlje.
But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth.
Bićete mi svjedoci u Sedonu i Yarraville i Melbourneu.
You will be my witnesses in Sedon, Yarraville and all of Melbourne.
Što Gospod zahtjeva u četvrtoj biblijskoj pouci od nas?
What does the Lord require of us in the fourth lesson?
Ivan 13. Poglavlje, 34.
John 13:34.
Da li netko zna na pamet?
Does anyone know it off by heart?
Novu vam zapovijest dajem da ljubite jedan drugoga, kao što ja ljubim vas. Da se i vi ljubite među sobom. I potom će svi poznati da ste moji učenici ako uzimate ljubav među sobom.
A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another. As I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this all will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another.
To ćemo moći kad budemo potpuno ispunjeni Duhom Svetim.
We will only be able to do that when we are completely filled with the Holy Spirit.
Peta biblijska pouka nam kaže, potom čuh glas gdje reče, koga ćemo poslati? I ko će ići za nas? A ja rekoh, evo mene, pošli mene.
The fifth Sabbath school lesson text tells us also, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then I said, here am I, send me.
Šesti stih. Ovo su riječi koje sam vam govorio još dok sam bio s vama, da sve treba da se svrši što je napisano za mene u zakonu i prorocima i psalmima.
Then are the words which I spoke to you while I was still with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses, and the prophets and the psalms concerning me.
Luka 10:27.
Luke 10:27.
A on odgovarajući reče im, ljubi Gospoda Boga svojega svim srcem svojim, svom dušom svojom, svom snagom i misli svojom i bližnjega svojega kao samog sebe.
He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind and love your neighbor as yourself.
Preći ćemo sada radi vremena.
Because of time, we will skip.
Na deveti stih.
We'll jump to number 9, the ninth text.
Jer kakva je korist čovjeku, ovo znamo svi na pamet. da sav svijet zadobije, a duši svojoj naudi.
We know this one off by heart. For what profit is it to man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul?
I 10. Stih koji smo trebali zapamtiti, Bog koji je stvorio svijet i sve što je u njemu, da, budući gospodar neba i zemlje, ne živi u rukotvorenim crkvama, nego Duhom Svetim u meni i tebi.
The 10th memory verse that we should be remembering is Acts 17:24. The Lord who made the world and everything in it is the Lord of heaven and earth and does not live in temples built by human hands.
13. stih.
13th Sabbath school text.
Kad će dakle sve ovo se raskopati, kakvim treba vama biti u svetom življenju i pobožnosti?
2 Peter 3:11. Therefore, since all these things will be dissolved, what manner of persons ought you to be in holy conduct and godliness?
Čekajući i želeći da bude skorije dolazak Božjega dana.
Looking for and hastening the coming of the day of God.
Neka nas Gospod pripremi za taj veličanstveni dan.
May the Lord prepare us for that wonderful day.
Amen.
Amen.
Ja mislim da će našoj sestri danas biti najteže.
He thinks it's going to be hard for me today.
Mi se nekako i menjamo, ide tačka za tačkom, osoba za osobom, ali ona uvek ostaje.
That's okay.
Dobro. Sada je vreme kada možemo svi imati i zajedno učestvovati.
Now is a time when we can all take part.
A to je naše dobrovoljno prilaganje, dobrovoljan dar.
And this is our free will offering.
I u dobrovoljnom daru povešće nas naš brat Manuel Tikulin.
And in leading us in the offering is brother Manuel Tikulin, pastor Manuel Tikulin.
Izvoli, Manuel.
Gde si, Ivan? Okay. Dobro jutro i Boži blagoslov još jednom svima.
Good morning and Sabbath blessings again.
Lijepo vas je vidjeti ovako velikom broju iz svih strana.
It's beautiful to see everybody from everywhere in a large number.
Volim uvijek iskreno pričati s vama.
I like to speak very honestly with you.
Prije 13 godina kad sam prvi put ušao u adventističku crkvu,
13 years ago when I first stepped into an Adventist church,
dobio sam jedan mali šok.
I got a bit of a shock.
Kazu se, ovi adventisti samo izbijaju novac iz džepa.
These Adventists, all they want is money from your pocket.
I to dva puta.
And two times.
I ja sam sad pozvan da vam izbim malo novaca iz džepa.
And now I've been called to ask for you to dig deep in your pockets.
Ali želim da ovo shvatimo malo sa drugčije stvari.
But I'd like you to understand this a little bit differently.
Vidit ćemo na kraju kako je ovo zapravo zahvalnost koju mi dajemo Bogu.
We will see at the end how this is something that we give out of thanks to God.
I kako je možda malo da dva puta damo zahvalnost.
And how it actually might be a little bit that to give it only twice.
Zato sam uzeo stihove iz Ivana 14. poglavlje, 1. do 4. retka.
And that's why I've taken texts from John 14, 1 through 4.
Neka se ne uzmiruje vaše srce i vjerujte u Boga i u mene vjerujte.
Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me.
U domu moga oca ima mnogo stanova, da nije tako, rekao bi vam, idem da vam pripremim mjesto.
In my father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you.
I ako odem i pripravim vam mjesto, ponovo ću doći i uzet ću vas sebi da budete tamo gdje sam i ja.
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also.
A kamo ja idem, znate i put znate.
And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know.
Mjesto.
Place.
St. Albans i sve ostale crkve su mjesto.
St. Albans, Sedan, all the churches are places.
Ali kako je to mjesto?
But what kind of place is it?
Bog, kad je prvi put stvorio mjesto za čovjeka, stvorio je prekrasan vrt.
When God first created a place for humans, he made a beautiful garden.
Zašto?
Why?
Da se susretne s njime. Tamo se svaki dan licem u licem susreto sa čovjekom.
Why? Because he wanted to meet with man and woman. He wanted to meet with them in that garden.
Korak napred, Abraham, koji je bio možda prvi stranac u stranoj zemlji.
A step further, Abraham, who was probably the first sojourner in a foreign land.
Na svako mjesto koje je došao, on je izgradio šator, ali i...
Every place that he came to, he would pitch his tent, but he would also do what?
Oltar, mjesto gdje će se susresti s Bogom.
He built an altar, a place where he could meet with his God.
I da onda idemo na kraj Biblije.
And then to, at the end of the Bible.
Na otkrivenje 22. poglavlje.
In Revelation 22.
Treći redak.
Verse 3.
Gdje nam kaže.
Where it says.
Ne, 21. pardon.
20, chapter 21.
Evo šatora Božjeg s ljudima.
And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold the tabernacle of God.
I on će prebivati s njima i oni će biti puk njegov.
The tabernacle of God is with men and he shall dwell with them and they shall be his people.
I sam Bog će biti s njima, Bog njihov.
And God himself will be with them and be their God.
A Bog nam i u vječnosti stvara mjesto gdje ćemo biti ponovo s njim.
And God is preparing for us a place
licem
in eternity where we will be with him face to face.
I kao što je Siniša rekao.
And as Siniša said.
Da li bi svi htjeli vidjeti Boga i braću i sestre licem u lice na nebu?
Would we like to see God and our brothers and sisters face to face up in heaven?
Da li bi voljeli vidjeti nove ljude na nebu?
Would we love to see new people in heaven?
Zato svaki dolar koji se da skupi danas ide na misiju kako ćemo privući ljude da se susretnu s Bogom.
Every dollar that is given today is going to mission to help more people become Adventists and faithful God keepers and to be able to meet their God.
I zato svako tromjesečje skupljamo prvi dio da bi ljudi imali priliku naći mjesto gdje se mogu susresti s Bogom.
And this is why every 13th Sabbath in Sabbath school we gather our Sabbath school offering for the 13th Sabbath.
I ako izgledamo iz te perspektive, mislim da smo dovoljno zahvalni da prikupimo dar za.
And we, if we look at it from that perspective, I'm sure we are grateful to be able to give.
Zamolit ću đakone da pokupimo.
We ask the deacons to please collect the offering.
Propovednikovo i mudre knjiga mudrosti.
the wise Solomon said in Proverbs,
da sve, ako se sećamo tih stihova, otprilike kako glase, kaže svemu ima svoje vreme.
This is in Ecclesiastes actually. He says that everything there is a time.
I onda nabraja za čega sve ima vreme.
And then he talks about all the other things that there is time for.
I jedno od nabrajanja kaže ima i vreme pevanju.
And he talks about that there is a time for singing.
I evo sad je upravo vreme za pevanje.
And now is the time for singing.
Naše sestre će proslaviti Gospoda kroz jedan song koji će sada izvesti.
Our sisters will praise the Lord through an item now.
Pozivam ih da dođu ovde naprijed. Pesme služe da se izrazi čovekova zahvalnost.
Songs serve to be able to express our gratitude and praise.
Radost.
Our joy.
Razne emocije ili bilo šta kroz pesmu čovek izražava.
So many emotions we can reveal through song.
Ali ne idu svake pesme u vidu pevanja.
Not all songs go into a tune.
Postoje pesme koje se mogu lepo izraziti samo recitovanjem.
Some songs exist that we express through poems.
I Bog je blagoslovio među svojim narodom da ne samo da imamo lepe glasove da pevamo, nego imamo i osobe koje umeju da izraze i na ovaj način svoju zahvalnost.
And God has blessed people that can express themselves through poetry and praise the Lord that way.
Jedna od takvih osoba je naša sestra Mikica Božović.
And one such person is our dear sister teta Mikica Božović, Mirjana Božović.
Imaćemo još recitacija i u popodnevnom delu, ali sada je na vreme za našu sestru Mikicu.
We would like to call her up.
Pozivam sestru da dođe.
Verujem da je većina od nas nekad osetila duboku tugu za rodnim krajem. Jedne takve večeri u takvom raspoloženju sam napisala ove redove pre 63 godine pri dolasku u Australiju. Mnogi su dani prošli od kad rekoh s Bogom zavičaju svom. Davno je presahla suza u kojoj nosih sliku rodnog kraja. Ostavih setnu pesmu mora, zanosnu lepotu naših gora, šapat zrelog žitnog polja, opojni miris grožđa i veseli smeh berača što zvoni kroz suton. Kad to beše, kad zadnji put videh majku svoju pod koprenom suza? Zašto plaćeš, majko? Pa idem u život bolji. U mislima svojim vidim novi kraj, okupan u suncu, obučen u dugu. I srećan, o kako srećan stvaram sliku budućnosti skore. Po zvezdanoj prašini mašte svoje hiljade snova, kao meteori se roje. Pitome doline, tihe reke, raskošno drveće, opojno cveće. Ptice svih duginih boja. Jaganci beli ko racvetale trešnje u rano proleće. Otežale grane od voća zrelog. Šetam po polju punom rose i tišina sreće puni mi grudi. Pesma slavuja uspomenu budi, na trepet zvezda, na šum povetarca, u toploj letnjoj noći, kad seđah na kamenu, dok talasi tiho pevahu uz morski žal. I podamnom sada more ključa i peni, kao da ima šta da kaže meni, or srce moje neće da sluša. Visoko u oblacima mekim kao majčina duša, slušam huku motora i divim se srebrnom krilu. I kad bacim pogled na rasuta sela, na zelena polja, na peskovite žale što promiču kao lastavice hitre. Ali pak mira ne da mi neki tihi glas. Ne nadaj se onome čega nećeš naći na celoj ovoj jadnoj planeti. Onu sliku mira i sreće o kojoj malo presneva, ti ponese iz Edema pre bezbroj stoleća. Svaka nit tvog bića nosi u sebi pečat izgubljenog prvog zavičaja. Uzalud lutaš po celom licu zemlje i tražiš da smiriš dušu svoju. Odmora nema i neće ga biti. Dok ne ugledaš novu zemlju moju, ta ćeš videti da ono o čemu sanjaš, to ćeš naći gore, mnogo puta lepše i raskošnije nego se nadaš. Večno proleće i blistava duga, ni jedna travka žute boje, ni jedan cvetić oborene krunice svoje. sve u cvetu, sve u raskošnoj lepoti. A ti, kao pečat ljubavi moje, naslijedit ćeš carstvo koje ti spremam. Al nestašna duša moja hrli ka novom svetu i raj hoće sad, zašto da čeka? Iz guste, magle i koprene oblaka zađo smo u jarko sunce ekvatora. Pogledom lutam i tražim pitome doline iz mojih snova. Mora ih biti, da to je moja otadžbina nova. Jarko sunce prži, vazduh težak od vlage, to su prvi utisci što ona mi dade. Svi moji snovi srušiše se ko kula od peska, mnoge suze zamutiše mi vid. Plačem, ali nije me stid, jer suze su duši ko rosa u sahloj travi. A budućnost bolja na iskustvu se pravi. Sad znam da snove nosim još iz raja, znam da na celoj zemlji nema takvog kraja koji bi bio obučen u lahor i dugu. I sad, kad sam našao domovinu drugu, moram da potisnem svu tugu, jer kolo života ne čeka. Mnoge su noći od tada prošle, noseći dane pune znoja i rada. I kad umoran sednem u suton obojen zlatom zalazećeg sunca, vidim konture sna i moje čežnje. I šapćem ispunjen srećom, dođi, o dođi spase skoro, uzmi ruke moje i vodi me u taj divni kraj, u moj novi zavičaj.
Da li znate šta je živa nada?
Do you know what live hope is?
To je nešto što je u čovjeku, al tako?
That's something that is in man, isn't it?
Neopipljivo, nevidljivo, ali je tu.
It's not tangible, it's not visible, but it's here.
Ali mi ćemo danas imati priliku da vidimo živu nadu.
But today we will have an opportunity to see live hope.
Naime, živa nada to je grupa.
That is a group today.
I ova grupa će danas proslaviti Gospoda. To je naša St. Albans grupa koja će sada imati učešće.
Living Hope will now praise the Lord.
Izvolite.
Say one word or one sentence. I was actually dedicated in this church. This was my church and my brother's church and my family's church twice. So I really have very, very special memories about this church, and I'm very privileged that our little group, Living Hope, is going to sing a song for you today. Enjoy it.
Sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing, love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. His body the bread, his blood the wine, broken and poured out, all for love. The whole earth trembled and the veil was torn. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah. Above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah.
Kao što sam već najavio, da je crkva izuzetno bogata sa mnogim interpretatorima raznih pesama.
As I've already suggested and said, this church is blessed with many talents of interpretation of song.
I opet ćemo sada slušati još jednu recitaciju.
And we will now hear another poem.
Sestra Ljiljana Jozef će recitovati i proslaviti Gospoda.
Sister Lily Joseph will now lead us through a poem.
Pozivam sestru Ljiljanu da dođe i da proslavi Gospoda.
Mnogima je poznato, a možda nekima ne, da ova crkva je prva građena ovde u Australiji. Još davna vremena naši vernici doseli ovamo, došli od naše bivše domovine, oni su je gradili. Ja bih kazala, crkva naša mati. Slava Bogu na visini, a na zemlji mir i među ljudima dobra volja. O, hvala ti, dragi Bože, što nam dovde ti pomože, da smo se ovako lepom broju okupili, da bi 60 godina naše crkve obeležili. Ti si uvek uz nas tu, u dobru i u zlu. Ti nas uvek pratiš na svakom koraku, na svakoj stazi. O, crkvo sedo, naša mati, nemoj tugovati. Došla su ti tvoja deca iz bliza i daleka. Budi vesela sa nama sada. Došla su ti tvoja deca iz sela i grada. Da svi zajedno proslavimo 60 godina tvojega postojanja. Pre 60 godina uz Božju pomoć složno smo te gradili. Radosna srca mnogo truda uložili. 60 godina brzo prođoše, samo koža nam se pomalo smežura, kosa srebrna, a nekima bela posta, ali srce mlada lačko osta. Crko naša mati, ti nas okupljaš kao kvočka pilići pod krila, na tvoja vrata mnoga deca uđoše, mir duši nađoše, duhovno mnoge si nahranila, mnogima si žeć ugasila. Za sve svemoćnom Bogu zahvaliti što je bio sa nama u prošlosti. Sećamo se onih lepih dana kad je podijum bio pun omladine, sedišta behu pune vernika, ali nažalost nije to tako sada. Neki od nas se oseliše u sela i druge gradove i tamo crkve sagradiše i Boga slave. Crkvo naša mati, mnogi koji tebe gradiše, nažalost se umoriše, Bog ih na počinak pozvaše. A mi smo još uvek tu u tebi, da sve večnog Boga slavimo, sa talentima što nas je obdario. O, raduj se sa nama danas, crkvo adventista u Sedonu, Melbourne, naša mati.
Imamo i goste iz naše konferencije ovdje danas.
We have visitors from our local conference.
I želimo im dobrodošlicu.
And we want to wish them welcome.
Predstavnik konferencije koji je danas sa nama je ovdje sekretar Craig Gillis.
Pastor Secretary Craig Gillis is here with us today.
I ja ga pozivam da dođe da nam uputi nekoliko reči sa ovoga mesta.
Call him up now to share a few words with us.
Thank you, and really pleased to be here on this high Sabbath day.
Hvala vam i veoma sam srećan što sam sa vama danas ovde.
When Pastor Miroslav invited me to come and be a part of this special day, I was a little bit worried.
Kada me Pastor Miroslav pozvao da budem sa vama ovog posebnog dana, malo sam bio zabrinut.
60 years ago, I wasn't even a twinkle in my parents' eyes.
Pre 60 godina nisam, moji roditelji nisu ni razmišljali o meni.
Fortunately, in my role, I'm the keeper of all the minutes of our executive committees.
Ali sreće za mene, ja sam onaj koji sada održava minute u našem okruženju.
And so I went back into our history to have a look at the beginnings of this church from the conference's perspective.
I zato sa pogleda naše konferencije želeo bih da pogledamo istoriju ove crkve.
Thank you. So what I found when I looked back into those minutes was that the very first mention of Sedan happened on the 24th of March 1960.
Ono što sam pronašla u našoj arhivi za crkvu Sedon, kada se prvi put spomenula, jeste 24. marta 1960. godine.
And there it was stated that A.J. Gathercol would be appointed the pastor of Sedon Company of the New Australian Believers, which is to be organized in the near future.
I tamo je pisalo da će A.J. Gathercol biti pastor sedonskog udruženja novih australijskih vernika koji će u bliskoj budućnosti otpočeti sa radom.
Within just a couple of months, a newly formed Sedon Company wrote a letter to the executive committee.
I samo u nekoliko par meseci crkva Sedon je uputila pismo našoj konferenciji.
And in that letter they re-stressed the earnest desire of the new Australian members to have the services of a pastor who understands the Yugoslav language.
I u tom pismu oni su ozbiljno napisali da bi želeli da imaju pastora koji će razumeti njihov jugoslovenski jezik.
And it was also noted that they are particularly interested in pastor Slavko Menstar.
I također su napisali da su veoma zainteresovani za pastora Slavo Manastir.
At that time he was ministering in the United States.
A on je tada bio propovednik u Sjedinjenim Državama.
Just a couple of months later, I'm just making sure that it works, has it? Yes, just a couple of months later, the executive committee held on the 17th of August in 1960, it was voted that we approve the organization of the Sedon Company into a church in the immediate future.
I tako se dogodilo da smo za par meseci, 17. avgusta 1960. godine, konferencija odobrila da ovo udruženje Sedon postane crkva u bliskoj budućnosti.
And then at the next constituency meeting, which is in January 1961, it was voted.
A onda 1961. u januaru mesecu bilo je izglasano
that two newly organized churches were by vote of the session received into the sisterhood of churches of the conference, namely Croydon and Sedon churches.
Da su dve organizacione crkve dobile titulu crkva i to su
approved the loan for the land at 21 Hotham Street, which was paid off within 12 months and prior to any working on the building taking place.
I tako naš konferencija je odobrila ovu pozajmicu i to se sve mogli su da otplate u narednih 12 meseci.
Within a few months the executive committee recorded that recorded that the union and the division would give a loan of £2,000 each, and the conference also gave a loan of £2,000.
I za nekoliko meseci Unija Australije i divizija su odlučili da će pokloniti 4000 funti kako bi pomoglo izgradnju crkve.
Sorry, I correct that. It wasn't a loan, it was a grant.
Znači, to nije bila pozajmica, već je to bilo odobreno, odnosno poklon.
So a total of £6,000 was granted to build the new church building.
Tako da su oni dobili odobreno 6000 funti.
Which is probably in the vicinity of about $150,000 today.
To bi negde bilo oko
150,000 dollars. And then on the 26th of April in 1962, the executive committee voted to approve the building plans with some slight adjustments to where the toilets were and some of the windows, etc.
I onda 26. aprila 1962. Imali su odbor koji odlučivao gde će šta biti namešteno, gde će biti toileti i tako dalje.
And also on the 23rd of August in 1962, another loan was provided to build the church building.
A također 23. avgusta 1962. godine dodatnih 2000 dolara je bilo odobreno od strane konferencije da se pomogne crkva.
I hope you can see that the Victorian Conference has always been very supportive of church plants, and in particular we're talking this morning Sedon church plant.
Voleo bih da primetite da je konferencija uvek bila za to da pomogne svim crkvama koje su u izgradnji, a danas pričamo o Sedon crkvi, pa su pomogli i Sedon crkvi.
At the moment we have about 19 church plants here in Victoria.
Trenutno imamo 19 novih crkava u izgradnji ovde u Viktoriji.
And to show how important church plants are, we appointed a church planting director in 2022.
A da bi pospešili ovaj posao, mi smo i odabrali posebnog direktora za rast crkava.
We currently have a membership of 11,645 members in Victoria.
A trenutno članstvo u Viktoriji naše crkve je 11,645 članova.
85 organized churches and 27 companies.
85?
Yes.
85 organizovanih crkva i 27 udruženja.
We see the need to continue to plant churches.
Vidimo potrebu da se izgrađuju nove crkve.
So that in another 60 years, in many other places, we'll be having celebrations like this, supposing our Lord has not returned before.
Da bismo u sledećih 60 godina imali i kod drugih crkava jednu ovakvu proslavu, ako naš Gospod do tada ne dođe.
May God's blessing be upon you, and as we move into the new year, may we continue to bear a light in this community for Jesus.
Želim vam blagoslove Božje i da zajedno nosimo Gospodnje svetlo ovom svetu ovde.
Thank you.
Hvala.
Kako vreme brzo prolazi.
How time passes by quickly.
Ne znam da li ste primetili, ali mi smo već u drugom delu.
If you haven't noticed, we've begun the second half.
Naime, nismo podelili danas kao uobičajeno na prvi deo i drugi, nego smo sve sastavili kao jedno.
Normally we actually divide our sessions into two sessions, the morning and the afternoon, but today we've actually brought it all together in one.
Ali po nekim programima se vidi da je već vreme za drugi deo.
But as we see by the program, it's already the time for the second part of it.
Tako je sad vreme za naš dobrovoljni drugi dobrovoljni dar.
And so forth, now we are come to the part where we give our voluntary offerings for the second half.
Stig za dare, znači na vreme, i pozvao bih sestru Nataliju Kuburić da nas vodi u darovanju.
Our verse for the offering is done by our sister Natalia Kuburić, so she's coming up to recite it for you.
Evo, kao što je pastor Manuel rekao, ja sam ovde po drugi put.
Just as our pastor has mentioned, I'm here now for the second time.
Da nas pozovem sve na prvo mesto na zahvalnost.
To call you up for the first part, which is for thankfulness.
U Lukinom evanđelju imamo zapisano jedno od velikih čuda, čudo oživljavanja, odnosno promene srca jednog velikog bogataša, čoveka, koji se na sve moguće načine trudio i borio da dođe do što većeg bogatstva.
Okay, as we begin here in the Gospel of Luke, one of the great miracles is recorded in Luke's Gospel, the miracle of reviving the heart of every rich man and a man who taught in every possible way to get more and more riches.
Velika je ironija da je to ime čovek Zahej ili Zakeus na grčkom koje je značilo čist, nevin, nepokvaren. A nema sumnje da je Zahej, da bi se popeo na poziciju starešine, odnosno carenika u Jerihonu, morao da učini puno prljavih i pokvarenih dela.
It's a great irony that his name Zacchaeus, or Zacchaeus in Greek, meant pure, innocent, uncorrupted, and there is no doubt that in order to rise in the position of an elder, a ruler in Jericho, Zacchaeus had to learn a lot of dirty and corrupt deeds.
Nećemo pogrešiti ako kažemo da je ovaj uzlogašeni carenik nagomilovao svoje veliko bogatstvo svojim nepoštenim i nasilnim metodama.
We won't be wrong if we say that this notorious tycoon amassed wealth through his dishonest and violent methods.
Ali sada, kada je Isus prolazio Jerihonom, ovaj uzlogašeni carenik bio je malog rasta, ali je želeo da vidi Isusa.
And while Jesus was passing through the streets of Jericho on his way to Jerusalem, where the cross was waiting for him, Jesus met Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus has a great desire to see Jesus.
Zahej se popeo na drvo, a Isus prolazi pored drveta i oslovljava ga po imenu Zaheju, siđi brzo dole, danas želim biti u tvome domu.
And because of his short stature, he climbs a tree and Jesus approaches a tree and addresses him by his name. Zacchaeus, come down quickly, today I should be in your home.
Isus ga ne pita, Isus mu zapoveda da siđe dole, a srce koje je do tada bilo puno prljavštine i zla, odlučio je da otvori svoj dom, ali i vrata svoga srca, kako bi Isus očistio sve što je u njemu bilo zlo i nečisto i što je greh uništio.
Jesus does not ask him, but commands him, and the heart, which until then was full of dirt and evil, decided to open both the door of his home and the door of his heart, so that everything that was evil and impure in him and that was destroyed by sin could be seen.
Na taj zahtev Isusa, Zahej oduševljeno silazi sa drveta i odgovara, čitamo u Luka 19.8, Gospode, Gospode, evo pola imanja svojega daću siromasima i ako sam koga zakinuo, vratit ću četiri puta.
And at that request of Jesus, Zacchaeus comes down from the tree and answers in Luke 19:8, Lord, Lord, here is half of my possessions I will give to the poor, and if I have robbed anyone, I will return as much as four parts.
Kakav čudestan preokret ovoga velikog bogataša, kakva razlika u odgovoru prethodnog mladića koje čitamo u 20-ak stihova samo ranije, kada je gledao Isus, bogatog mladića koji odlazi jer nije mogao i nije želeo da se odvoji od svog bogatstva i tako je izgubio spasenje.
What a miraculous turnaround of this rich man. What a difference in the response of a previous rich man whom just 20 verses earlier Jesus watched walked away with from him because he did not want to part with his wealth.
A drugi bogataš, prezren i nepošten, otvara svoj dom Isusu i velikodušno sada deli svoje bogatstvo koje je stekao i kao rezultat toga dobija priliku za večni život.
And the other rich man, despised and dishonest, opens his home to Jesus and many souls share their wealth with others and as a result have an opportunity for eternity.
Otvaranje vrata našega doma Isusu, otvaranje našega srca Isusu, dovodi do radikalne i čudesne promjene, a to su rezultati da darežljivost postaje spontana svakidašnjica našega života i promjena našega srca.
Opening the door of our home to Jesus and opening the door of our heart always leads to radical and miraculous results. Generosity becomes spontaneously our everyday life as a result of a changed heart.
Na kraju, naši dobrovoljni darovi sadrže nešto mnogo, mnogo više od materijalne vrednosti. Oni pokazuju duhovno stanje našega srca. Darežljivost počinje sa otvaranjem srca Isusom, ali završava se sa otvaranjem našeg novčanika.
And in that part, in the end, our voluntary gifts contain something much more than material value. They show the spiritual state of our hearts. Generosity starts with an open heart and ends with an open wallet. A heart surrendered and open to God to enter it and feel it from all impurities will be spontaneously moved to grateful giving, which exceeds all expectations.
Srce predano Isusu i Bogu da u njega uđe i očisti ga od svih prljavština, bit će spontano pokrenuto na zahvalnost davanja koja nadmašuje sva naša očekivanja. I dok se razmišljamo sada o ovim rečima koje smo čuli, priložimo naše dobrovoljne darove.
And with grateful giving, and which exceeds all our expectations, as we ponder these words, we offer our voluntary gifts. Can we please call the deacons to collect the money, please?
Dragi naš nebeski oče, neizmerno smo ti zahvalni za ovaj divan subotni dan. Hvala ti za mogućnost da smo se okupili u tvome domu. Neizmerno smo ti zahvalni za sve blagoslove koji si nam blagoslovio, koji si nam podario. Ali te najiskrenije molimo da nam pomogneš da otvorimo na prvom mestu vrata svoga srca, da možeš ući u njih, da bi mogao živeti u njima, a mi da bismo mogli onda živeti po Tvojoj volji. Pomozi nam da možemo donositi dobrovoljne darove kako bi Ti mogao iskoristiti za propovedanje evanđelja koje će treba da se završi da Ti što pre dođeš. Ovo Te molimo i predajemo se u Tvoje ruke i ostajemo Ti večno zahvalni. Oče naš nebeski, amin.
A da vas pitam, da li ste nešto primetili u dosadašnjim muzičkim tačkama koje su bile? Ko je uglavnom učestvovao? Odlično ste zapazili. Uglavnom žene. Pa šta je sa muškarcima? Ali muškarci ne pevaju, ali šta? O čemu se radi?
Women sing nice.
Dobro, ne računamo orkestar, samo ove koji pevaju. Da. Evo sada ćemo imati jedan dokaz da i muškarci znaju dobro da proslave Gospoda. Jel sad grupa koja će izaći je muški sastav, uglavnom sve muškarci.
Yeah, the band that's coming up front now is a predominantly a man group. Or men's group.
Pozivam vas da dođete.
I'm calling you up to do your song.
Hvala Bogu i na muškim glasovima.
Thank God even for male voices.
Sada je na redu jedan video koji ćemo gledati ovde na ovim ekranima.
Next in line is we're going to have a video that you'll see on our big screens here on left and right.
A neće biti prevoda sa ovog mesta, nego će biti gore, odozgore će biti prevod.
There won't be a translation from the front here. The translation will actually take place from upstairs.
Tako da onima kome treba, ima redari koji će deliti slušalice, da samo dignu ruku da se jave da im redar da slušalice.
If you require headphones to understand the translation, please put your hands up and our church leaders will...
Prevod će biti na engleskom, znači govorit će se na našem jeziku, a prevod će biti na engleskom jeziku.
It will be spoken in the Yugoslav language or Serbian language, but the translation will be in English on the headphones.
Tako da se pozivaju oni koji engleski govore da da ako njima trebaju slušalice.
So only English understanding people, please put your hands up for headphones. Thank you.
Nalazimo se u Sedon crkvi, na mestu gde su ljudi sa vizijom pre 60 godina počeli da grade ovu crkvu koja je danas lepo i veliko zdanje. Ono što mene zadivljuje vezano za ovu crkvu je vizija koju su oni imali i sa kojom su počeli da grade. I danas bih volao da pitam vernike koji se sećaju ili posvećenja ili se sećaju tih prvih godina. Volao bih da ih pitam kakve su emocije imale kada su sedeli prvi put u novoj crkvi na svom jeziku i imali bogosluženje. Kakve su ih emocije tada preplavile, kako su se osjećali? Evo, pitaćemo sada vernike da nam odgovore.
Osjećala sam se presretna. Tako mi je bilo kad sam ušla, to je bila puna crkva i galerija. Još i sa strane stolice sve pune. Toliko nas je bilo puno. To je bilo prekrasno, ne moram to se ne more opričati. Predivno, to je puno srce, puna crkva, to je bilo... Ne znam se izraziti toliko kako sam bila sretna.
Moj prvi susret sa Sedom crkvom je bio prazna, nezavršena crkva i kako su svi ostavili, čim se završio posao, svi su došli na rad u crkvu.
Imao sam emocije kada sam došao prvi put u crkvu, ljudi su bili ljubazni, bili su spremni da pomognu u svakom pogledu. I da nam se posao nađe, i da nam se stan nađe, i banke, i sve ostalo ono što je za život potrebno. Tako su ljudi bili živo zainteresirani.
Mene je jako važno zbog to što sam se krstio u Sedom crkvi 27.9.67. Bio sam 17-godišnji dječak. I što je za mene ostalo jako važno, zato što su nas automatski odmah uključili u subotnu školu kao učitelj da se učimo, a drugo, bili smo uključeni i u muzičke tačke kao i za omladinu i vodstvo omladine, tako da smo imali pjesme, recitacije i sve što nam je bilo interesantno da nas zadrži u crkvi. To je meni bilo vrlo važno ono vreme.
Dragi moji prijatelji, braće i sestre, želim u prvom redu da vas pozdravim Božjim blagoslovom. Moj dolazak davne 1969. godine u Australiju u Sedom crkvi je bio veoma, veoma radostan zato što sam, kad sam ušao prvi put u Sedom crkvu, bilo je oko 400 vernika. Uglavnom, mi nismo imali mesto gde bi mi sedeli, izuzev ako je neko bio bolestan, onda je to bilo mesto prazno i mi smo mogli da sednemo na to mesto. Bio je priliv mnogo naroda koji je dolazio i normalna stvar da se moralo kao i košnica rojiti, tako da su prvi vernici napustili Sedon i otišli za Sidney, druga grupa je otišla za Brisbane, a posle kraćeg vremena izrojila se i St. Albans crkva koju smo gradili i jedan dobar deo vernika je otišao tamo.
Prvi susret je bio iznenađujući.
iznenadila me ljubav onih prvih graditelja crkve, kako su se oni trudili i sve činili, a ništa nisu imali, a sve su imali.
Velike emocije, da ti pravo kažem, ali neću da ti kažem na duhovnom polju kakve su bile, nego da ti kažem na fizičkom, u fizičkom smislu kako su bile. Sela sam u stolicu i stolica se nije izmakla ispod mene. U ribarskom holu smo imali klupe. Ako sedneš na jedan kraj i nisi pazio, ode klupa zajedno sa tobom na pod. I ovo je bilo super, znaš, da lepo sediš kao čovjek u crkvi i da uživaš u onome što se događa oko tebe. Drugo mi se jako sviđalo što je pod bio super, novi pod, izglancan. U ribarskom holu pun trnja, sve stare, stare neke daske, pa pustiš dete da puže po podu, pošto smo imali puno male dece, a kad dođeš kući poslije, prvo moraš da vadiš trnje iz njihovih ručica ili nožica. To su sve stvari koje su možda ostale u mom sećanju, pozitivne stvari. Onda, radost, ona koja je vladala tog dana, to je neopisivo. Koliko smo bili srećni svi toga dana. Kako smo se svi lepo obukli, čak i šešire natakli, imali rukavice, imali šimi cipele, obavezno, onda se nosile te špicaste cipele. Svi smo imali, muški imali crna odela, neke tanke crne mašnice i mislili smo kako smo jako lepi u to doba. Ali bili smo srećni, bili smo mnogo, mnogo srećni. 3 godine smo sanjali dan i noć, radili i sanjali o ovom času. Konačno je taj čas i došao.
To je bilo, naroda je bilo puno. Svi su radili, svi su učestvovali. Sad niko neće da radi.
Bili smo radosni zato što su sve naš narod.
Dobro.
Sve bili naši i onda se, s kojima se nismo znali, upoznavali se i tako. Ja nisam baš bila radosna. Zato što sam ostavila tamo majku i sestru, nesposobne. A mama mi kaže, idi sine sa svojim mužom.
Kad sam ušao prvi put u crkvu, nije bilo patosa. Bile su samo grede i mora da hodaš između njih gredama. I onda sam išao, galerija nije bila, samo je kostur bio postavljen, nije bio ceiling gore. Bili su koji su radili tu, bili su svi veseli. To je dobrovoljno se radilo i još su novce davali i ja sam među njima dao novce. Nije bilo nikakvih problema, bilo je može biti svake nedelje po 30, 40 i 50 radnika je bilo, tako da se radilo na veliko.
Prvo sećanje jeste kada sam bio u ribolskom holu i bio sam jako nevaljeni. I to nije bilo onako prihvatljivo u crkvu kao mali dečak. I mama me iznese vani kao da mi nekako daje neke opomene i znate šta mislim na te opomene. A jedna draga sestra je došla da me spasi, a ta sestra se zove Mira Jakovac. I ja se dugo nje sjećam kao mladić, jer ona je imala veliki utjecaj na mene kako sam ja rastao u crkvi. A moje drugo sjećanje je okoli gradnje, kada su zidari gradili i zidali, i tu su bile te, kako da bi kazao, one scaffolds.
Skele.
I tu su ovo braća bili jaki hrabri i nisu se plašili, a nije jedan nije pao.
Pa bilo je lijepo, imali smo društvo svoje i svirali smo i redom smo dolazili smo u crkvu redovno. To je bilo i učiteljski čas redom, to je i petkom se skupljalo i bili smo radosni. Ja sam volio, uvijek sam svirao u orkestru, i čak imam čast da kažem, moja teta Ilonka Piščak je, ona je bila jedna koja je radila puno za moji roditelji, poslije kad su došli, moj tata isto je bio i pjevao u zboru i dan danas ima slike i snimljeno o tome orkestru koji je bio, ja sam uvijek svirao bas ili mandolinu. To su lijepe slike. Danas više nismo mladi, nažalost, mnogi nema više. Nažalost, tako je. I još bi naglasio da ja sam bio među prvima koji smo prvi put farbali Sedon crkvu. Tu je moj brat bio, Stjepan, ja i brat Ribarić je došao u to vrijeme. I bili smo vredni. Radili smo da nismo jednog dolara uzeli. A da, bilo je teško nekad. Poslije posla došli i radili u Sedon crkvi. A da. I bili smo radosni.
Pozdrav našim Sedončanima. 60. godišnjica od kako se organizirala Sedon crkva. Želim da izrazim moje čestitke, pošto ne živim u Balbonu više. Osjećam se kao kad dolazim kući. Uvijek sam imao taj osjećaj. Nijedna druga crkva nije mogla da me privuče kao što možda privuče moj dom. Odakle sam izašao i onda iz koga sam otišao. A tu sam bio u tom domu od dana rođenja, možemo da kažemo, dana rođenja crkve Sedon. Zbog blagoslovi, kršćanski prozor, Eben Erser.
Bila je velika radost i veselje, to smo jedva čekali da crkva bude sagrađena i da uđemo u nju svi zajedno, da se radujemo, da slavimo Gospoda na veliko. I to je istina neiskazano, radost velika, neiskazana. To se ne može opisati. I bili smo svi sretni i svi smo bili zadovoljni. I služili smo Gospodu onako kako treba. I puno prijatelja je bilo i radili smo na tome. I mnogi su se krstili i poslije su oni doveli svoje još prijatelje pa je bilo još više. I crkva je rasla i rasla. I tako, a mi smo postepeno starili, kao što vidite, sad smo starci već, koji smo ostali živi, vrlo nas malo ima, vrlo malo. Mnogi moji prijatelji, nema ih više. Starešine, različite službe što su imali, otišli su. Eto mi je jako žao, ali hvala Bogu, jednog dana bit ćemo svi zajedno kad Isus dođe, pa nas uzme zajedno. I radovat ćemo se za uvijek i hvala mu to i čekamo na njega i radujemo se njegovom dolasku. To će uskoro biti. Ja vjerujem čvrsto u to i vi svi vjerujete i tako će biti. Hvala Bogu za to jer nas on ljubi. Hvala mu za to. Amen.
Hvala lepo na ovim odgovorima. Imam još jedno pitanje za vas. Crkva je izložena raznim uticajima i mi kao pojedinci prolazimo kroz različite situacije u životu i mnoge stvari se menjaju. Crkva toga vremena imala je neke jake karakteristike. Koja mislite da je najlepša karakteristika iz crkve iz 60. i 70. godina ili možda najjača karika koja danas bi mogla da bude bolja, a nije kao tada što je bilo? Šta biste izdvojili kao nešto posebno?
Pa najljepša bila je zato što je bila puna mladi. Sve mlade duše, sve mladi, mladići, djevojke.
Najlepša karakteristika je dečja subotna škola, kada smo imali sestru pokojnu Dobrilu Davidović i sestra Mira Jakovac. Dečja lekcija svake subote je bila drugačija i to je bila jedna kutija sa pesak i cela lekcija je bila načinjena u toj kutiji. Samo otvorenje crkve bilo je 13 osoba koji su se krstili i moja mama je bila u tih 13 osoba.
Subotna škola je funkcionisala i ako neko ne bi došao u subotnu školu, onda bi se raspitalo i onda bi se zadužio neko da ga kontaktira tog istog dana zašto nije došao, tako da se posjeti ako je bio bolestan ili ovo, ako mu treba pomoć. Tako da su ljudi bili spremni u svakoga trenutka da razumiju svakoga i da svakome pomognu.
Za mene vrlo je važno bilo ne samo što smo bili prihvaćeni, nego u vreme kada je subotna škola imala preko 50 učitelja i mi kao djeca smo sjedeli u traga i slušali kako ljudi koji znaju i uče nas na koji način da priđemo ljudima, na koji način da budemo učitelji. Gore smo imali 34 razreda. Mi smo kao mladi bili u 4 razreda gore na galeriji i za nas je bilo to vrlo važno da učitelj jedan stari uvijek bio sa nama. Tako da smo se menjali, svake subote bio jedan drugo. A drugo, što se tiče samih pjesama, muzike i brige starešina i brata Manestra, koji nam je jako puno pokazivao način na kako da se radi i budućnost Sedona. Sedan je građan da se raširi. Njegov cilj je bio fantastičan. I možda nismo kao djeca shvatili to do danas, zbog toga što njihova želja bila da postane naš narod, da se proširi po celoj Australiji. To je, automatski ljudi su odlazili kasnije za Sydney, za Adelaide, za Perth i gore za Queensland, za Brisbane. Tako da je bilo vrlo interesantno promatrati ljude na koji način rade starešine i vode crkvu i jedinstvo.
Karika ili uspjeh crkve u Sedonu je što smo bili složni, jedinstveni, imali smo isti cilj, da bi što više naroda saznalo o Božjem spasenju i zato smo svi bili učesnici. Odmah posle par subota bio je Appeal for Mission, gdje sam ja bio uključen sa mojom suprugom bez engleskog jezika u timu. I sjećam se da sam taj dan skupio $35, što je u to vrijeme bio veliki novac. Još u samoj crkvi bilo je puno omladine, puno mladih, srednjih godina i organizovano je bilo za piknik. Po 2 basa smo išli na piknik i slavili, hvali Boga, u prirodi. I to je bio jedan od glavnih uzroka koji je Sedon crkva okupljala.
Jaka karakteristika je crkve što sam ja primijetio, što su bili neobično ljubavni i gostoprimljivi. A bili su došljaci koji ništa nisu imali, ali sve su davali od sebe. Da koji god dođe, da bude lepo prihvaćen i primljen.
A znaš šta je najbolje? Koga god si pitao da li hoće nešto da uradi, glavački se prihvatio posla. Čak za jedan posao bilo je 2-3. To mi se čini da danas nekako je malo je izvetrilo iz naše sredine. Hor je bio fantastičan, kad kaže fantastičan, svi smo pevali, svi smo bili mladi i oni koji su znali i koji nisu, svi smo jednako dolazili. A znaš kako smo dolazili? Autobusima, jer većina nije imala auto. Onda neko je sa posla došao, ali svejedno svi smo bili redovni na vežbama. Bio je tu u Melbourneu sabor, pred svaki Božić je bio sabor. I Sedon je imao najveći deo programa uvek. Bio je hor, bio mandolinski orkestar, bio je čuveni kvartet koji je Sedon imao i dupli kvartet, pa to je bilo pesme na sve strane. Muzički život je bio na veoma visokom nivou. Mislim, za nas koji smo laici, koji nismo bili profesionalci, ali nijedan sabor engleskih crkava se nije mogao zamisliti bez Sedon crkve.
Što su lijepo radili svi zajedno složeni. To je bilo divno. Bilo je svega, bilo je svašta. Ali opet je crkva radila. Bilo je naroda, imalo je naroda da radi. Da.
Što je bilo lijepo, bilo je, nama bilo lijepo zato što smo mi tu došli, tamo kod nas nije bilo toliko dosta u crkvi. A ovo kad smo došli, bilo nas je puno, pa onda smo se upoznavali i bili smo radosni.
Najjače jeste bilo što su mladi, svi smo mladi bili. Od starih vrlo retko koga vidiš, od starih. Sve je mlado bilo. manje više svi singlaši, neoženjeni, a devojke su bile jedno 5-6 devojaka. I što mi se najviše sviđalo u crkvi, kada uđeš, to je bilo pristojno oblačenje. Svako je obuk ono što je najbolje i što je najlepše. Velika je razlika prije 60 godina i sada. Ne samo u našoj crkvi, nego bilo u kojoj crkvi drugoj.
U ono vreme članstvo crkve je bilo jako puno i braća i sestre su bili jako bliski jedan prema drugima. Ja sam to kao mladić to vidio i to osjetio. I to je isto djelovalo na nas kao djecu, jer subotna škola je bila velika subotna škola za našu djecu u ono vreme. I ne samo što su naši roditelji družili zajedno kao braća i sestre, mi djeca isto smo se družili i to dugo godine.
A bio je pastor manastir koji je bio u to vrijeme u crkvi, kao pastor crkve, on je izidao tu crkvu. I tako je bilo, jako je lijepo bilo.
E, ovako da kažemo nešto o subotnoj školi. Danas, koliko znamo i vidimo, da vrlo malo ljudi dolaze za subotnju školu. To je, nažalost, šteta za svakoga, jer u subotnoj školi se puno može naučiti i puno saznati, biti bliže Bogu još. Ali eto, viš, takva je situacija, ne samo u našoj crkvi, nego u svima ostalima je ista stvar.
Melbourne je veliki grad i kao takav on ima mnogo adventističkih crkava. Moje zadnje pitanje za vas je, od svih tih crkava, zašto ste izabrali baš Sedon? Zašto još uvek dolazite u Sedon? Zašto ste član crkve Sedon?
Pa zato što sam, kad smo došli, tu smo našli nekako toplinu i vedrinu i radost i zadovoljstvo. I to nas je povezalo sa svima i bili smo sretni. Ne možem to iskazati koliko sam zahvalna Bogu. Pa šta bi ja da nemam tako povjerenja u Gospoda i moju braću u Kristu, u vjeri. To je jako važno, to je jako važno, povjerenje u Gospoda i u braću.
Zato što smo stigli prvo u Melbourne i nije nas interesiralo da idemo dalje, jer crkve još nisu postojale u drugim states.
Naš jezik, naš narod, jer mi smo poseban narod i imamo, da imamo razumevanje između sebe i tako, ali sa Englezima ne možemo. Englezi su sasvim drugačiji narod.
Kad smo došli u Australiju, prvi 6 mjeseci smo bili u stvari u spotu crkvi, gdje smo učili engleski, zbog to što nismo znali engleski, bilo nam je možda malo teže. I mama i tata su odlučili nakon jedno vreme da dođemo na emigrizaciju koju je brat Manesa rišao i tada smo mi odlučili smo da, u stvari mama i tata su odlučili da ostanemo u Sedunu. Iako je bilo engleska crkva, iako smo se družili sa drugim engleskim crkvama, što je bilo nama interesantno kao omladini, imali smo jako puno zajedničkih časova sa Poljskom crkvom, pjevanje i menjali smo se svaku godinu, smo odlazili u posjetu sa time što smo imali propovednike, mlade propovednike koji su bili s nama i imali smo koncerte i druge stvari što su se održavale u crkvu i što je nas je zadržalo da budemo ovdje. Iako ima jako puno crkava, engleskih crkava, u ono vrijeme možda nije bilo 88 kao što imamo sada, ali želja da budeš u svoj i govoriš na svoj jezik, to mi je uvijek bila radost i ne bih htio da idem negdje, a da nemam korist od toga.
Pa onda nije bilo crkve druge naših naroda, 87, to je bila prva crkva. Kasnije su se izrodile druge crkve, ali Sedon je bila majka crkva.
Sedon je nekako bio centralno smešten, pa svi smo stanovali nekako dosta blizu i bilo nam je zgodno da dolazimo tamo. Plus, tamo se govorio naš jezik, a mi smo bili poznati po kasapljenju engleskog jezika. Pa zašto bi onda tamo išli da se brukamo kad smo mogli lepo svoj jezik da govorimo i da slušamo. I dan danas, eto, tamo je tamo je želja za, da čujem svoj jezik i da praktikujem to. To me očuvalo da ostanem tamo. A i to je majka naša crkva, to ne bi nikad ostavila.
Što je naš narod i ovi naši rodbina koji su došli prije nas, dolaze tu u crkvu.
Sedon je bio najviše članova u Melbourneu. Sedon je imao 400 člana plus 120 dece. Bili smo poznati po omladini. Sedon je imao 120 omladine. Tako da su iz drugih crkava dolazili da gledaju našu crkvu i postavili su pitanje šta vi radite, kako vi radite da zadržite vašu omladinu da je u crkvi. Jer njihova omladina napušta crkvu i odlazi.
Kakvi su programi bili?
Programi su bili, svake subote je bio program. Najmanje dve, tri tačke je bilo. Bilo je i hor, bilo je sastava i muških, i orkestar je bio. Mikica Božović je vodila onda orkestar. U ono doba Steva Lipković i Katica Bikicki, oni su manje više hor, a i sastave su vodili. A dečji program, kad deca izađu gore, ne znaš šta je lepše. To je toliko dece bilo da to ne mogu da ti opišem kakva je velika radost da vidiš decu.
Evo pitanje je zašto sam još član Sedom crkve. Nakon te duge godine, imam 65, zašto bi išao negdje drugde?
Zašto imam živa iskustva u Sedom crkvi, što sam se uvijek radovala.
Što se tiče ovog pitanja, mogu samo da kažem, jedini razlog je što sam ostao u ovoj crkvi je što sam uvijek bio sa službom zauzet i želeo sam da služim narodu. S tim, koliko god sam imao mogućnosti i talenta, ja sam činio od sebe što sam mogao i to je Bog blagosiljao. Crkva je uvijek bila živa, puna rada, puna truda i u to vrijeme imali smo puno i dece. Radio sam sa decom. Imali smo preko 100 dece u to vrijeme. Tako da je uvijek služba nekako me zadržavala u toj crkvi.
Zato što je naše, na naš jezik. Zato volim. Pa volim. Ne znam engleski. Znam, ali ne znam.
Da presečemo uspomene sa opet malo pesme.
To now have the situation with another item, a song.
Da vas pitam, šta vam se više, šta je lepše zvučalo? Ko lepše peva, one ženski glas ili muški glas? Ženski sastav ili muški?
I'd like to ask you a question. Which one do you think sings nicer, the female choir or the female items, or the male singing?
Lep je i ženski sastav bio i glas, lep je bio i muški sastav i glas, ali znate šta je još lepše od toga?
Both the female and the male are both beautiful and they are both equally as good as each other. But you know what's special?
Još lepše od toga je kad se ovo dvoje spoji.
The nicest of this is when those two that sing separate join together and sing together.
Kad se muški i ženski glasovi udruže da slave Gospoda.
When the male and female voices unite to give glory to God.
I to ćemo sada učiniti sa horom Sedom crkve.
And we're going to now give you that item with the choir from Sedom Church.
A kroz pesmu koju će hor pevati, se izražava zahvalnost Gospodu za sve što je činio za ovu crkvu.
And the song that's going to be performed has a special title to it, which is All Glory and All Thankfulness to Our Lord God.
Jesu ljudi zidali, gradili, davali novac?
Yes, people did build and helped in developing this church and also gave money.
Ali je Bog taj koji je učinio da to sve ima i da odobrovolji ljude i on je sve blagoslovio.
But it was all done by the will of our Lord and it was all glory goes to him for everything that we have.
Stoga kako i kaže pesma koja će sada biti, dostojan si Gospode.
And as the song says, all things belongeth to thee, to our Lord.
Thank you.
Hvala Gospodu za ovaj divan program danas i za toliko različitih tačaka.
We want to thank God for this wonderful program today and for these special items that we've had today.
Došli smo do naše glavne tačke proučavanja Biblije sa našim gostom.
We've come to the main part now where we're going to study the word of God with our visitor.
Naš gost danas, posebni gost ovog sabora je Igor Mitrović.
Our special guest for this sabor is Igor Mitrović.
Iako magister teologije, radi kao direktor Adre Jugoistočne Evropske unije.
He's a master of theology and he's also like the head of ADRA in
u Jugoistočnoj Evropskoj uniji.
In the European Union sector.
Southeast European Union. South to je puno ime i prezime, je li tako? Mi smo ga sinoć predstavili i želimo da te Gospod vodi u proučavanju koje ćeš podeliti sa nama.
We want to thank you for your service with us yesterday and the beginning of today. Thank you.
Izvoli.
Najvredniji deo iskustva iz prošlosti.
The most valuable thing in the past.
I najvrednija sećanja koje imamo.
And the most important memory that we have.
Su istovremeno naša najveća slabost.
Those things that expose our biggest weaknesses.
Ja sam u najboljim godinama, kao što vidite.
I'm in my best years of life, as you can see.
Što znači da sam na savršenom raskršću između mladosti i zrelih godina.
Which shows everyone that I'm on the crossroads between youth and the transition into older.
To znači savršena mera mladosti, lepote, pameti i iskustva.
That shows my good looks and my beauty and my youthfulness that I've got.
Jedan među vama mi je rekao, moraš pomenuti selo iz kog si došao.
Someone said to Igor, you've got to mention the town or the village that you came from.
I to selo Cvetke u centralnoj Srbiji.
Cvetke.
Cvetke.
What's
you just say Cvetke.
It's
international.
Right, is yes. It? Okay. So that's a town called Cvetke, which is in central Serbia. A village.
But the heart of a city.
But the heart of a city.
Kako mi idu godine, sve se radije vraćam u vreme kada je bilo mnogo dece, baš kao vi kad pričate, bezbrižno.
As I look back in the past, I noticed one thing was the multitude of young people that attended churches.
I te emocije koje te vraćaju nazad. I te emocije koje te vraćaju nazad.
And those emotions that return you back to that time.
Su sve snažni magnet koji ti ne daje da se da pogledaš napred.
They are sort of like a hindrance for stopping you from looking forward. They hold you back.
I naravno kada ste u godinama koje su bliže kraju nego što su početku.
And as you're in the years that are closer to the end rather than the beginning.
To je normalno. Neko će da kaže, pa i nemam čemu da se nadam osim novoj zemlji.
That's normal for most people because they've got nothing to hope for except for the new world that's coming.
Ali možda i to čak nije do kraja tačno.
And possibly that's not even absolutely correct at the end.
Tako da danas se sećamo neverovatnih vremena iz prošlosti.
That's why today we remember unforgettable times of the past.
Ona su se dogodila.
They've happened.
Ali shvatamo i prošla.
And we realize what's passed by.
Ja se sećam mog detinjstva u selu. Ja se sećam mog detinjstva u selu.
I remember my youthfulness in the village.
I ona su mi, ta vremena su mi dalje izvor energije.
And those times have given me boosts of energy.
Ali ona su se dogodila i prošla.
They've happened and they've passed, they've been gone.
Iskustva s Bogom koje sam imao, ko zna u kojim sve aspektima života su se dogodila.
The experiences that I had with God have happened and they've passed, they've been gone.
Ali su da, prošla.
But they've gone.
Prošla sedmica se dogodila, ali je prošla.
Last week has passed by, but it's now gone.
Uvod u propoved pastor je dao, ali je prošao. Sad sam ja ovde.
The entrance or the introduction into the sermon was done and it's passed now and now I'm here.
I svima nama, bilo da smo momak od 12 godina,
and to all of us, whether we're a youngster of 12 years
old, koji revno namješta mikrofon,
who regularly repairs or sorts out the microphone,
ili smo devojka od 25 godina ili čovek od 50,
Well, unless we're a young lady of 25 years of age or an old man of 50, did you say?
Ovo pitanje nas objedinjuje sve.
Those questions bring us all to the same point.
Okay. Kuda sada?
And the question is where now?
Šta je sljedeći korak?
What's the next step?
Ili da smestimo to ovaj sveti ambijent Boga koji je među nama.
Or to apply that aspect with God being in the presence
of us. Or to apply it in the context of God being with us.
Yes.
Kuda nas Bog sada poziva?
The question is, where is God calling us now?
Ko god da smo.
Wherever we might be.
I nas kao crkvu.
And also us as a church.
Nisam imao mnogo mentora, ali Bog mi je davao mentore na razne načine.
I didn't have many mentors in my life, but God gave me a few of them in different ways.
I jedan od njih je ovaj čovjek čiju misao vidite na ekranima.
And one of them was this man which you see his name appearing on the actual display.
I zamolit ću Pericu da pročita I'll help you.
Yeah, okay. Which one you want?
Because the text is too small even for me.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't have it actually.
No. That's really? Only in English.
Kako ćemo se snaći sada? Bravo. Okay. Tako je. Zato mi služi ovo. Well, come with me. Okay. Or you go there or wherever you want.
Microphone. That's all.
Okay, bravo. Yep. Actually, I'll read it out in English.
Okay.
The place God calls you to is the place where your deep gladness and the world's deep hunger meet. Mesto na koje te Bog sada poziva je tačka gde se tvoja duboka radost preseca sa najdubljom potrebom ovog života, ovog sveta. To znači da gdje god da te Bog poziva sada, to mjesto ćeš da prepoznaš jer će se dogoditi da ćeš ti biti ispunjen u toj službi.
Remember the question here is where God is actually calling you in this present time, you're meant to be in the providence of God's plan.
Da. I koje god da je to mjesto, to će biti mjesto gdje se tvoja radost dešava, gdje doživljavaš radost.
And that place where you will find yourself will be where your deep gladness actually prevails from.
A u isto vrijeme ćeš biti od koristi ovom svijetu, tu gdje jesi.
And at the same time you'll be of good value and good use to the world at that particular time.
Zašto je ovo bitno?
Why is that important?
Zašto je ovdje jedna sveta mudrost prisutna?
Why is the importance of this presence at the moment so important here?
Zato što ponekada smo neku pogrešnu lekciju negdje pokupili da Bog te poziva.
Because in the past or present we've sometimes heard callings that are not actually correct and led us in the wrong direction.
Da te Bog poziva na neki zadatak, na neku službu.
That God has called you on some sort of service or some sort of deed.
Da ćeš raditi svoju obavezu, svoj zadatak, ali nećeš doživjeti radost, jer će ti biti muka i teško.
Where God will call you into a certain service and thing where you might not actually enjoy it and you won't receive gladness and joy out of it because it actually becomes a bit of a burden upon you.
Bog možda poziva ljude na tako nešto, na zadatak, na službu koja neće biti njima izvor radosti.
God can call many people and might call you to do a service that may not be too pleasant for you at the time.
Ali znate koji je to Bog?
But you know which God that is.
Paganski Bog.
It's a pagan God.
Ne Bog kog je otkrio Isus Hristus.
Not the God that we know as Jesus Christ.
So, ako doživite nešto što liči na poziv i radite dugo nešto što vas ne ispunjava, to nije bio poziv od Boga.
So if you do a chore or a task that doesn't actually fulfill you and it starts to cause problems and trouble for you, know that that wasn't a calling from God.
Taj poziv mora da bude od koristi ovom svetu. Da ga isceljuje na neki način.
that calling has to be of value, it has to be of purpose for the presence of God.
Ali mora da pomaže i da ti cvetaš u svom životu.
But it has to help you, and it also has to help you to flourish in this world.
Inače to nije poziv od Boga.
Otherwise, it's not a call from God.
Ali na koje pozive mislim, da malo konkretizujemo? Na koju vrstu poziva mislimo?
Let's concrete what sort of callings we're talking about here, so we can get a bit more of a clarity on it.
Ja sam naučen da postoji najsvetija vrsta poziva, to je kad Bog pozove nekog da bude pastor.
I've realized that the most holy callings I've ever experienced is when someone is called to be a minister.
Svi ostali su tu nužni, dakle da budu inženjeri, poljoprivrednici, ali to nije poziv od Boga, to je ono što radiš da bi preživeo.
And there are those other duties which are called upon, which is work, whether you're an engineer or a builder or whatever, they're not calls that have come from God, they're just jobs that we do to survive in this world.
Ali ne znam da li se slažete, mislim, čak me ne interesuje da li se slažete, to nije tačno.
It doesn't matter to me whether you agree with me or not, but that's not correct.
Svaki poziv koga doživiš, da ideš na ovo mesto,
for every calling that you receive to go to that place,
je svet poziv.
Is a worldly call.
I ne postoji rangiranje, ovo je Božji poziv za tebe kao inženjera koji je malo manje svet od mene za pastora. To je, ne postoji.
It doesn't exist a calling where you've been called as an engineer, but that calling is sort of belittled in relation to the calling that you might be as a minister.
Ili poljoprivrednik. Farmer.
Oh, or if you've been called as a farmer.
Ili doktor.
Or a doctor.
Ili accountant.
Or an accountant.
Ili šta hoćete da kažete? Možda glumac.
Or whatever you want to call, even an actor.
Ako Bog pozvao nekog da služi svetu kroz glumu, ko sam ja da kažem nije od Boga?
If someone's been called to be a actor in the world, who am I to say that it's not a calling from God?
Opet, složili se ili ne, ako Bog pozove, nema ja šta da se slažem, tako ga je Bog pozvao.
That's the situation if God has called you
ili
in
sportista.
A certain thing, or a sportsman, if God's called you that, who am I to interfere and say otherwise?
Da li možda znamo u Bibliji za koga se prvo kaže?
Do we know in the Bible for who it says first and foremost in relation to this?
Da ga je Bog pozvao na neki posao i da je Duha Svetog spustio na njega.
That God called this particular person to a service and the Holy Spirit was placed upon him.
Da je to bio toliko svet poziv da je Duh Sveti direktno empowered, opunomoćio tu osobu.
The power of the Holy Spirit was so great upon this person that it actually brought him into a movement to go and do something different.
Once again. Car Saul, možda, dobar kandidat.
King
dobro.
Saul.
Još neko? Apostoli, dobro.
Apostle Paul and Pavle. Disciples, yep.
Ali da baš u Bibliji kaže da ga je Duh Sveti, da se spustio Duh Sveti na njega.
But the Bible actually specifically talks about one in the Bible that it was that the Holy Spirit.
Samson je dobar kandidat.
Samson? Samson's another
okay,
one.
Okay, još neko? Okay, Jovan Krstitelj.
John the Baptist.
Još neko?
Any others?
Kada je zidan hram? Kada je hram zidan?
When was the altar or the sanctuary built?
The temple.
Or the temple. When was the temple built?
Kada je prvi onaj zidani hram bio?
Yeah. When was the first building, the temple, first ever built?
1963. godine ili tako nešto.
1936. You're saying it's a joke.
Osoba koja je trebalo da organizuje posao sa gredama, sa ceiling, sa temeljem.
The one that was ordered or asked to prepare the temple, the building, the structure, the metal, the wood, the stone.
U našem prevodu mi ga kažemo Veselejlo se zvao. Veselejlo, but who knows how it's called in English, so it doesn't matter.
That's no idea, I don't know.
Je bio prvi koji se u Bibliji pominje da ga je Duh Sveti obdario. Bio je graditelj, bio je fizički radnik.
Okay, there was a guy, obviously, the name is very hard to pronounce, but he was a builder, and he was the one that was first called to actually build the temple.
Bio je u znoju, imao je olovku ovde, imao je velike šake i pentrao se.
Yeah, he was quite a builder in himself. He had his pen stuck in his ear, he had his work, he had a worksheet, he had everything prepared.
Bog poziva ljude na razne stvari.
God calls people on unusual things.
I to daje dostojanstvo tebi i tebi i tebi koje možda ti niko nije rekao da ga imaš.
And that sets a course that
a dignity.
Dignity.
Mm-hmm. Dostojanstvo.
To every individual that is actually placed in their position to do the work that they have.
Tako da gdje god da te Bog poziva, na koji god korak naredni,
so whichever step that God asks you to take and to direction to head,
to može biti poziv u okviru tvog zanimanja, čime se baviš.
That could be around the things that you're familiar with and the things that you like to play with.
Al to može biti i poziv.
And that can also be a call.
Na neki sljedeći korak kada je tvoje zdravlje u pitanju.
That can also be a call when it relates to your health.
Ili tvoj porodični život.
Or your what porodični?
Porodi, family life.
No, your family's life.
Ili tvoj šta god, služba u crkvi naravno, misija.
Whatever your duties might be in the church or whatever your mission might be in relation to the church.
Postoji jedan nezaobilazni ingredient. Dostojanstvo.
There is one important ingredient that is prevalent in the whole thing, and that's dignity.
Ali to je početak.
But that's just the beginning.
Vi imate ovaj standardni primjer.
You have a standard example.
Avrama.
Abraham.
Sa razlogom je standardni.
With an example, it's standard.
And hajde da pročitamo sad.
Let's
početak poziva koji je upućen Avramu. Jer krije ono što je tebi potrebno i meni danas, dok čekamo poziv.
Okay, let's read from the scriptures those things which were called to Abraham from God to do.
Možemo da čitamo engleski tekst samo.
We can read the English version of it only. Okay. After these things, God tested Abraham. He said to him, Abraham, and he said, here am I.
Not that one. This right
on. Genesis 12. Okay. Now the Lord said to Abraham, go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing.
Avram, još uvijek nije imao ovo drugo ime Avram, nego Avram.
Abraham still didn't receive his name Abraham, it was Abram.
Je čovjek koji je paganin.
Because of a man that was pretty much considered pagan.
Bio je deo vrlo napredne civilizacije u Uru, Haldejskom.
He was a sort of a ranking person in his life that he was living beforehand.
Da. I grad se zvao Ur u zemlji Haldeja.
And the town was called Ur, and it was in... Chaldea, is it? Okay.
I kada Bog prilazi njemu, mi ne znamo kako Avram razume tog Boga. Da li jednog od mnogih bogova ili je već osjetio da je to jedan jedini Bog koji postoji, jedini pravi Bog.
And as God was approaching him, he didn't really recognize whether it was God from heaven or whether it was some other God that was actually approaching him and talking to him.
Pošto je to bilo mnogo božačko, politeističko društvo. Ljudi su verovali u mnoge bogove.
Because at that time there were many, many gods that were out there and many people believed in multiple gods.
I Bog mu se obraća i primetite reči koje su naglašene u ovom tekstu sada.
And God comes up to him and listen to the words that are mentioned here in the scriptures.
Idi iz svoje zemlje.
Go from your country.
Od svog roda.
And from your kindred.
Iz kuće svog oca.
And from your father's house.
Znate kako? Čak i kada ste zbog muke bežali iz one zemlje u Australiju. Čak i kada ste zbog muke bežali iz one zemlje u Australiju.
Even when you yourself ran from your foreign land or your country of origin and birth and you ran away because of troubles.
Ono tamo je bilo vama poznato.
That over there in the former land was knowable to you.
To je bio dom.
That was your home.
Možda ste u subotu trpeli šikaniranje, sramoćenje.
Yep. Maybe you received, mocking and
zbog subote u školi.
And, and you were picked on because you were going to school on Sabbath.
Ali to ipak bio vaš kraj. Mirisao je poznato, vaša porodica, vaš jezik.
But because that was your area and you knew it and you could smell it and you could understand it, it was your region, it was a place that you
Tako da odluka da dođete ovde je bila pretpostavljam.
Therefore the decision for you to come here was predestined.
Potencijalno rešenje za deo problema,
a potential reasoning for the problems that you had.
Ali izvor gomile novih problema za koje ne znate kakvi će biti.
But there was a road in front of you that was full of other problems that you could not even foretell.
Za Abrama je bilo još komplikovanije.
For Abram it was even worse.
Ako možete poverovati, još komplikovanije.
Even more complicated for him.
On je išao iz civilizacije koja imala najbolji standard života poznat u onom delu sveta.
He left a region which was considered well endowed and had everything going for it, so he left a place that was very, very precious and good and rich.
Imali su klimu, ne znam da li je negde Melbourne ili Brisbane, pošto shvatio sam da nije baš isto, ali bila je nije baš isto, shvatio sam.
There was the climate wasn't really the climate was pretty good, but he doesn't know whether it was more like Melbourne or Queensland, but
ali
you know,
somewhere in between. Air condition je bio tamo za ono vreme.
But at that time there was air conditioning over there.
Bilo je grejanja.
There was heating.
Bilo je vodovoda.
There was many waterfalls.
Na parkingu 2-3 auta.
And in the garage there was 3 or 4 cars.
Lagodan život.
The life was pretty easy.
Ideš supermarketom, trpaš hranu, ne razmišljaš šta rastavljaš.
Life at that time you could just go and purchase whatever you needed to at the supermarket and come back and load your car and
sve što treba imaš tu.
Everything that you needed was right there.
Tu je tvoja porodica.
That's where your family is.
I Bog kaže izađi i idi da budeš do kraja života pathfinder.
And God says to Abram, leave your family, leave all this and go out into no man's land, as we call it, and be a pathfinder.
Gde da idem?
Where to go?
Vidjet ćeš, pustinje, jako, lepo, žuto.
You can see the desert's nice and yellow and flat, it's all good.
Nema problema s komšijama, pošto ih nema.
You don't have any problems with neighbors because you don't have any.
Kuća?
But the house?
Daću ti preručnik kako se gradi šator, bit će odlično, veruj mi, avantura kako nisi do sad imao.
I'll give you some plans on how to build your house or your tent. Don't worry, it'll be an excellent tent.
Grejanje?
How about heating?
Hlađenje?
Cooling?
Pa, shvatit ćeš da ti je jako malo odeće potrebno, veruj mi.
But as he was told, you know, don't worry, you won't need much clothing, so that won't be that important.
Toalet?
How about a toilet?
Naučit ću te jedan koncept koji se zove poljski WC.
I'll teach you a concept which is called a Polish toilet.
Well, it's not a Polish. We don't want to offend any Polish
no,
people.
So, polski WC.
I was trying to find it. Like dig a hole and, yeah, no.
Oh, like an outhouse.
Outhouse, bravo.
Outhouse,
that's
okay.
Outhouse.
You speak more.
Okay. Yeah, outhouse.
We'll set up an outhouse for you.
I ako vidite koliko puta se pominje reč svoje, svoje, your.
And if you notice how many times the word your is mentioned in that verse.
Vidite da Bog od početka, od kad se obraća ljudima.
You can notice that right from the beginning when God touches people and speaks to people.
Je iskren.
Is sincere.
Ovaj poziv će biti poziv da iz svog velikog komfora izađeš u nešto nekomforno.
The calling is going to be something that's going to be most difficult for you because it's going to take you out of your comfort zone and take you out into a place which you have no idea about.
I kao da ga bocka svaki put kad kaže your.
And it's like he's actually pricking him and touching him personally when he says your all the time. It seems to be targeting him directly.
I kao prijatelj koji koristi malo reči.
And like a friend who uses very little words.
Biće neprijatno, ali će ti biti bolje.
It's going to be uncomfortable for you, but it'll be better for you.
I to je cela filozofija Boga u tvom i mom životu.
And that's the whole philosophy of God in our lives and your lives.
On je kao trener.
He's like a trainer.
Koji kaže, vidim da možeš bolje.
That says to you, I can see you and I can see that you can do better.
Ti možeš i tu da budeš negde stoti na rang listi.
You could be here on a ranking of what, 100?
Ali ja vidim da možeš biti prvi.
But I can see that you could actually be number one.
I dođi za mnom, bit ćeš prvi.
And come and follow me and you shall be number one.
Za 15 dana bit će ovdje događaj.
In 15 days there's going to be a happening.
Kog ću da propustim, tako da sljedeći put ono kog zovete, pozovite malo kasnije. Australian Open.
Oh, right, okay. I'm totally lost at that. And there's going to be an Australian Open, a tennis tournament that's going to be happening soon.
Kada je sadašnji broj jedan u svetu osvojio prvi Grand Slam ovdje.
When the number one in tennis won his first Grand Slam here in Melbourne.
Krenulo je odlično, ali onda imao godinu dve jako loše.
He started off really well, and then he had one or two years of sort of dropping off his ranking.
I sada je poznat razgovor koji on imao sa tadašnjim trenerom.
And now the conversation is understood that he had with his current trainer at the time.
To je bilo suza, bilo je dizanja ruku, ne mogu više, ne vredi.
There was tears and woes and everything, and he was lifting his arms and saying, I can't do this anymore.
A onda je trener Marijan Vajda rekao.
Then his trainer Marijan Vajda said to him.
Šta ti hoćeš od karijere?
He said to him, what do you want from your career?
Jeli dalje želiš da budeš najbolji?
Do you still want to be number one?
Hoćeš, znači.
He goes, you do. Do you want it?
Onda zapni i bit ćeš.
Zapni,
lajhas, izvini. Hard work, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Well, put in the hard work and you shall be number one.
Bog je jedini pravi trener zato što te stalno gura napred.
God is our one and only true trainer because he constantly pushes you forward.
Ne zato što ima neke bolesne snove kao roditelj koji nije sam ispunio neke ambicije pa onda gura na dete.
Not like not someone that actually has a will to place burdens upon you like a parent who hasn't fulfilled their own life and their own task and then they're trying to put it onto their child.
Već zato što te voli.
But because he actually loves you.
I kao što reče, mislim, sestra Bosiljka ili Mirjana malopre.
As our sister Mirjana said earlier on, or Bosiljka.
Moraš se kretati, inače ćeš umreti.
You got to move forward, otherwise you will stop in life and die. You got to keep moving.
Kada pogledaš unazad? Jer ovo je dan kada gledamo u retrovizoru unazad.
When you look in your television of life, and like today we're looking backwards, looking
back in the past. A svi mi, makar bili dečaci ili najstariji, kao što je sestra u videu bila, imamo isto iskustvo, imamo gde da gledamo u stvari, imamo gde da gledamo.
But like the young ones of the past and us in the future, we can see where we can look back at those
things. Kad si imao iskustva sa živim Bogom.
When you've had experiences with a living God.
Kad je to bilo na kraju sjajno iskustvo koje te sad hrani.
When that was a blessed experience with God and that's feeding you.
I mi pamtimo obično taj kraj koji je dobar.
And we usually remember those things which or the ending which is good.
Ali setite se, uvek je počelo teško. Uvek je bilo teško na početku.
But you have to remember in life it always started more difficult before it got better.
I ovo je bila prva stepenica za Avrama koja je bila teška.
And this was a first step for Abram, which was going to be a very difficult one.
Ali tako se stiču iskustva. Nema drugi način, nema drugog puta.
But that's how you learn from life's experiences. There is no other road. There is no other way.
Seti se, Bog uvek zove da izađeš iz zone komfora.
Remember, God constantly calls you to come out of your comfort
zone. Zato kad sada te Bog poziva da izađeš iz zone komfora.
So now when God asks you to come out of your comfort zone now.
Nemoj da budeš svilen. Silky, if that's a word.
Silky, silen.
Too soft, softy.
Yeah. Okay. Don't be a softy, which is the best word. Like a princess. Okay.
A princess. Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Nice word.
Budi malo. Nemoj da previše na svoje osjećanja misliš.
Yeah. Don't spend too much time on your feelings.
I nemoj da te zbuni ta neprijatnost u tebi. To je normalno. Svi to doživljavaju.
And don't let those feelings affect you and discomfort you from the point of what you need to do.
Neko je rekao da u srednjem veku ljudi su se mnogo više žrtvovali.
They said that people in the Middle Ages sort of worked a lot harder.
Mnogo ih je biralo, mnogo njih je izabralo da budu monasi, askete, da se odriču, da ne jedu, da žive u pustinji.
Yeah, many of those in those times were called to live a life of sacrifice.
I da žrtve sada više nema. Retko ko hoće, svi su u komforu.
Yep. And now those sacrifices of life are no longer necessary.
A to nije tačno.
But that's not correct.
Evo, spavamo kod naše drage porodice Mary.
Ko spavamo?
Spavamo mi, da, svako večer.
Okay. So right now at the moment, as guests of our friends, we're staying at their place and sleeping at their house every night.
I askete nas bude svako jutro. Askete, like monasi.
Monks wake you every
morning. Yeah, every morning.
Okay. And we were woken every morning by monks.
Koji će da rade od, ne znam, 7 sati, ali ustaju da trče okolo u 5 sati. I work out.
And these little monks wake up at 7 o'clock, but they get up at 5 o'clock and they start running around us and waking us up.
Ako
by 7.
Ako pogledate neprofesionalne rekreativce, one koji idu u gym.
Yep. If you look at those people who attend gyms,
ili sportiste,
or sportsmen,
ili ljude koji vežbaju 5 sati ovo,
or people who practice 5 hours on a piano,
ne nedostaje ljudi koji se žrtvuju danas. Ljudi se i danas žrtvuju.
People still have to sacrifice. There's no effort without or we can't make
tako
an effort without sacrifice.
Što bismo rekli u našem narodu, ne gine ti žrtva. Dakle, ne možeš da izbegneš žrtvu.
Yep.
Ne možeš da izbegneš.
As they say to life, it says you can't avoid the troubles or the challenges that you need
tako
to go through.
Tako da očvrsni, budi tough i biraj borbu jer te na drugoj strani čeka radost.
Yep. So in that case, be tough and be strong and follow through with the task and on the other end you'll be glad.
I kad imaš to iskustvo kao Avram,
and when you have that experience like Abram,
otišao si u pustinju, pitaš se da li si bio lud što si prihvatio poziv.
You wonder to yourself, were you crazy for hearing that voice telling you to go to the desert?
A onda Bog ređa jedan blagoslov, jedan znak, drugi blagoslov.
And along the way, God then starts to place things in front of you that show you the blessings that He's got for you.
Dobiješ ono što si znao da nikad nećeš imati, jer si shvatio.
You start to receive those things which you never thought you would because now you realize.
Da li zbog sebe ili zbog žene ne možemo imati dete?
Is it because possibly because of my wife or myself that we can't have a child?
Dobijaš dete.
You're going to receive a child.
Dete koje liči na Saru.
A child that resembles
i na mene.
On
kaže Avram.
On the father and the
ima
mother.
Isti nos, ima iste
like
uši.
Looks like me.
Hoda slično. Moje dete, dobio sam svoje dete.
I've got my own real child. He looks like me. He's got my nose. He's got my ears. I've been blessed. Walks like me.
A onda, ne samo što si to nekad maštao, pa si odustao od tog sna, pa dobio.
Yep. And even though you, in your own mind, doubted those things and looked at them from afar and thought, no, that's not going to happen, you received them.
Nego se pred tvojim očima obistinjuje da dobiješ od Boga što nisi ni sanjao, ni poželeo da sanjaš.
The things that happen are amazing because the blessings that you receive and the things that you receive from God are things that you didn't even contemplate receiving.
Polako, ali sigurno, ti si imao neko parče zemlje tamo, u Sedonu si kupio. Ili
you in the way that you're living
u svoj, life. U svojoj staroj zemlji. Okay. Imao si neko parče zemlje.
In your old life you had a piece of turf, a piece of land.
Sad polako, čitava zemlja postaje tvoja, Hanan.
And then all of a sudden out of that the whole region, the whole land of
polako,
man becomes
sigurno
yours. But slowly but surely, you get that.
I sve opet okay.
And then everything starts to be okay again.
Stvarno, bilo je dobro što sam poslušao Boga.
It was actually quite good that I listened to God's voice.
Ali Bog je trener.
But God is a trainer.
I nešto kasnije, u 22. glavi, prilaziti i dolazi novi poziv.
And then later on, as we read on in Genesis chapter 22, there's another calling for Abram. And I'll read it to you. It's Genesis 22, and it says, after these things God tested Abraham, he said to him, Abraham, and he said, here am I. He said, take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah, and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains that I shall show you. So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his donkey, and took two of his young men with him and his son Isaac. He cut the wood for the burnt offering and set it out and went to place it in the distance that God had shown him.
Prošli put sam našao snagu da izađem iz zone komfora.
Last time I found the strength to come out of my comfort zone.
Ali ne znam da li vi Ali ja, kada me drugi put Bog pozove na neki potez,
I don't know about you, but I know about myself. Next time when God calls me in a calling to do something,
bude opet teško.
It will be again difficult.
Avram ovde kaže, tu sam, Gospode.
Abraham says here quite clearly, here I am, Lord.
A Bog, kao što je malo pre ponavljao reč, izađi iz svoje kuće, iz svoje zemlje, iz svoje porodice.
And like in the previous verses, God says to Abraham, he says, take your son, your only son. So he's referring to him again.
Ovde mu kaže upravo to. Uzmi svog sina, svog jedinog sina i žrtvuj ga.
And he says this specifically to him. He says, you know, you've got to come out of your comfort zone. You've got to take your son, your only son, and you've got to sacrifice him.
Ti verovatno kao što ja verovatno znaš na koji potez te Bog poziva i znaš da je ključan za tvoj život.
In the question that we have here is, you know, when God's calling you and he's calling you in a specific way, how is that way relevant and most prevalent in your life?
Ja verovatno znam na koji potez me Bog poziva sada u mom životu. Ja verovatno znam to već.
I truly do know myself what direction God's calling me to walk in.
I verovatno znaš i ti na koji te potez Bog poziva sada. Bilo da je zdravlje, porodica, posao, crkva.
And you yourselves also know what calling God has for you and the path that he wants you to walk.
I taj potez će zahtevati neku žrtvu.
And that journey that you're about to take is going to require a sacrifice. You will feel it.
Šta je Avram osetio kad ga je Bog pozvao da žrtvuje sina koji je simbol najvećeg blaga koji ima on sad? To je najveće blago. Šta je Avram osetio kada je čuo ovaj poziv?
What did Abraham feel when he was asked to sacrifice his beloved and only begotten son that he had at that time?
Je li bilo sve jedno Avramu?
Was it just by the way for him?
Je li skočio i to uradio onako zviždući neku pesmu, onako uz pevajući neku pesmu, radostan?
Did he sort of jump up with glee and gladness and joy and do this with, you know, singing in his heart?
Po svemu što znamo, on je dobro proverio da li ovo Bog govori njemu.
With everything that we know, he really sort of studied and paid attention to whether this was actually coming
from
God. Da
li je stvarno poziv od Boga?
Was the calling truly coming from God?
I kada je potvrdio da jeste od Boga, od živog Boga, od Jahve, od Gospoda.
And when he actually realized that it was coming directly from God and it was God's calling to him,
znajući,
knowingly,
da je prošli put,
that last time,
bilo čudno,
it was unusual and
kad ga je Bog pozvao,
when God called him,
ali da je poslušao,
but he did listen to him,
da je bilo teško,
that it was difficult,
ali da se nije pokajao.
But he didn't regret it.
I sad je uradio ono što vojnik uradi.
And this time he's doing what a soldier would do.
Fokusirao se na prvi sledeći korak.
He focused himself on the steps ahead, the first, second and third steps.
Rano je ustao.
He woke up early in the morning.
I pripremao se.
And he prepared himself.
Nije razmišljao o mori.
He didn't think about the future or anything.
Fokusirao se na prvi sledeći korak.
He just focused himself on the first and second points or steps that he needed to take.
I možda je rekao, Bože, ako mi stvarno budeš oduzeo sina.
And he may have thought to himself, God, if you truly do ask me to take my son's life.
A kroz njega i celo obećanje o narodu, o zemlji, o blagoslovu koji će kroz njih na ceo svet otići.
And the blessing that he was told that through his son all nations shall be born and be blessed by him or through him.
U redu.
All okay.
Ja ću raditi ono što mi je zadatak ovog dana.
I'm going to do the task that has been given to me to do today.
Rano ustajem.
I'm going to get up early in the morning.
Doručkujem. Osedlam magarca.
I'm going to have breakfast and then I'm going to saddle my donkey or my ass.
Napunim gorivo.
I'm going to fill it up with petrol.
Navigacija, morja, vrh.
I'm going to get out my GPS and set my course for the mountain.
I krenem.
And I take off.
Ne razmišljam unapred, nego se fokusiram na te korake koji su prvi.
I don't think about what's happening in the future or later on. I'm focusing on what I need to do right now and here and now.
Kada gubiš 2-0 u setovima,
when you lose 2-0 in sets,
i 5-3 u posljednjem setu,
and in the further set you lose 5-3,
i vodi protivnik 30 ništa,
and your opposition is leading you 30-0 or 30-0,
fokusiraš se ne jao kako ću sad break uraditi, pa da li ću moći nakon toga svoj game, pa onda da li ću osvojiti makar taj set, ne razmišljaš o tim stvarima, ne ideš previše unapred.
You don't think about how am I going to break that the set that's going forward at the moment, at the time
of the game. Ne brineš o problemima koji nisu sad tvoji problemi.
Yeah, you don't focus on the problems.
Koji je tvoj problem sada?
Your problems later on. What are your problems today?
Namesti se dobro.
Set yourself up properly.
Okay. Budi koncentrisan.
Be concentrated or focused.
I fokusiraj se na return.
And get yourself ready to do a proper return.
Na prvi sljedeći zadatak, ne dalje od toga.
On the first or second serve, not later on.
Po strani sport i loptica, da je to možda banalna stvar. Nije bitno što je to sport i loptica, nije ni najvažnija stvar na svetu.
It's not important that it's a game or tennis or a ball game or whatever.
Ja ovdje govorim kao ilustraciju za ovu životnu priču.
But I'm talking more of the example for these lively experiences.
Kad se sad na fakultetima izučava mentalitet tog prvog tenisera sveta, kad se sad već izučava na fakultetima mentalitet.
When I was studying the status or the mental status of those sportsmen.
Zapravo je ovo predmet koji se studira.
One of the subjects that is studied predominantly is this.
Kako fokus na sljedeći zadatak koji ti je Bog dao.
How the focus on the second, on the part that you must do next.
A prepustiš Bogu sve ostalo. Prepustiš Bogu sve ostalo.
But what you do then is you actually release to God all other things.
Je pristup koji ti daje najbolje šanse da bude dobro na kraju.
Because the chances are that it'll be the greatest at the end if you follow these first steps.
I pogledajte šta se dešava.
And then see what happens.
Takav pristup je tom čovjeku doneo rekorde.
And those steps forward actually brought the rewards or the
u toj banalnoj stvari zvanoj sport.
And in those
unimportant, yeah.
Yeah, that those things showed the result of what.
Ali je princip zapravo kako živjeti život.
But the principle here is how to live your life.
Rose early.
Rose who?
Rose early.
You rose early. Yep.
Sorry. Settle your donkey.
Namestio svoj.
Sorry. Rose early, settle. Yeah.
English here. Rose early, settled his donkey. Yep.
I korak po korak. A Bog će dalje voditi.
And step by step, and God will lead the
way. U najgore slučaju.
In the worst scenario.
Stvarno ću bez sina ostati.
In the worst case scenario, I'm going to end up without a son. I'm going to lose my son.
Ali sam prošli put naučio.
But last time I learned.
Kad me Bog pozvao.
When God called me.
Bilo je čudno.
It was unusual.
Ali kad sam prihvatio njega,
but when I understood him and accepted his
kad sam
word,
se žrtvovao,
when I sacrificed
myself, nakon toga se nisam pokajao.
But on the end I did not have a regret.
To znači da sada dobre su šanse ako Bog zove.
Now the chances are better that if God is calling you,
žrtvuj se.
Sacrifice yourself.
Da kad se žrtvujem, neću se pokajati kad pogledam unazad.
Yeah, so the point is when God always calls you to make a sacrifice, you'll never regret that you made that sacrifice.
I uradiš to.
And you do it.
Zato je bitno ređati iskustva sa živim Bogom.
That's why it's important to line up those experiences with the living God.
Nova iskustva.
New experiences.
Gradiš na prošlim.
You build on your past.
Ali prošla postaju, prošla iskustva mogu postati
the last experiences could become
tvoja tamnica.
Your darkest moments.
Zvuči čudno. Your dungeon.
Your dungeon. It could end up your dungeon.
Zvuči paradoksalno.
Yeah, sounds like a paradox.
Tvoja prošla iskustva mogu biti čak tvoje prokletstvo.
Your past experiences or your dungeon or dark experiences could actually be your enlightenment.
Curse. No, your curse.
Your curse. Mm. Okay.
Ako ih koristiš ne kao odskočnu dasku za nova iskustva,
if you don't use them as a jumping board or a stepping board for new experiences,
nego se zarobiš u finoj,
or you
but you trap yourself.
Yeah, you sort of cement yourself into
u finoj,
in fine,
omamljujućoj,
developed.
Omamiti.
Omamiti. To je reč. Anyone omamiti, help us
znači
with that
da
word?
Onako popiješ neke lekove koje te omame.
Oh, right. To yeah, sort of knock you out a bit. Make you a bit groggy.
Bravo, groggy. Nostalgiji, kako je to bilo nekad.
Yeah, on that nostalgia on how it was in the past.
I ovo važi i za nas u 80-im godinama.
And this is important to us in the 80s.
I za nas u 30-im i za nas u 10-im godinama, ako to postoji.
And to those who are in their 50s and also those who are in their 20s and their 30s. And the young 10-year-olds as well.
I kada na kraju putovanja generacije koja je putovala kroz pustinju.
And at the end of the people that traveled through the wilderness,
Mojsije pokušava da iza njih sumira iskustvo.
Moses in his own way was trying to humble them and guide them in the experiences that they had.
On ovako sumira. Pogledajte tekst u 5. Mojsijevoj 8. Ovako sumira put.
He looks at the road ahead and he applies it and describes it in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 8.
Zato što gledati u retrovizor nije dovoljno, treba razumjeti šta to vidiš u retrovizoru. Treba razumjeti to.
Yeah. For looking back in the rear vision mirror, you can't just look back. You need to understand what you're looking back at and what you've seen.
You can read it out.
So it says here in Deuteronomy number 8, it says, remember the long way that the Lord your God has led you these 40 years in the wilderness in order to humble you, testing you to know what is in your heart, whether or not you would keep his commandments. He humbled you by letting you hunger, then by feeding you with manna, with which neither you nor your ancestors were acquainted, in order to make you understand that one does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of the Lord.
Bog te nije mučio zato što je sadista.
God did not hassle you or give you a hard time because he's a sadist.
On je tvoj trener.
He's your trainer.
On vidi šta možeš postati.
He can see what you can become.
I ne može da se pomiri, ne može da se pomiri.
And he can't chill out and be calm about this.
Da ti odustaneš od najboljeg što može biti u tvom životu.
That he lets go of you and doesn't perform the best and give you the best training that he knows that you can become.
I želi da ti da iskustvo koje nisi ni sanjao da možeš imati.
And he wants to give you an experience and a time to feel the things that you never even experienced or never even knew that you would ever encounter.
Ja sam uvek voleo da čitam.
I always used to like to read.
I da tako sam na teologiji završio i čitao that, do smrti.
Do smrti.
Yeah.
I love to read and I also love to read so much that that's how I spent most of my time
when
I was
studying
theology.
Ali sam uvijek bio plašljiv. Bio sam uvijek plašljiv.
But I was always a bit afraid.
Da probam nešto izvan toga.
To try something beyond that.
Postao sam pastor.
I became a pastor.
Bog je dao iskustva da u misiji, dao iskustva da naučim kako Bog podupire mene i crkvu.
I learned things through mission work and I also learned a lot about what God wanted me to do in my church organizations and what I was asked to do.
Da budem samo jasan, ja pričam o ovome kao primjer jednog od vas.
Just to be clear, I'm talking to you as an example of myself, just to you guys, so you can
bilo
understand.
Bilo da ste pastor ili inženjer ili farmer, potpuno je svejedno. Putanje su mnogo slične zapravo.
The examples are not that different between each individual, whether you're a pastor, farmer,
potpuno
or just an engineer. It's not important here.
Ovo je samo neki primjer, ilustracija, case study, ako hoćete.
This is just an example, like a case study for you guys.
Bio sam pastor u jednoj beogradskoj crkvi 7 godina.
I was a pastor in a church in Belgrade for 7 years.
I bio
years,
sam veoma razočaran.
And I was very, very sad.
Da sam shvatio da sam nekompetentan za taj posao.
Nisi šta?
Competent.
Ah, incompetent. He felt that he wasn't competent to be a minister.
Crkva imala mnogo potencijala, ali ja nisam znao da im pomognem da se organizuju. Pokušavao sam, ali nisam uspeo.
Yeah, the church had a lot going for it, but he felt that he wasn't capable of performing those things that the church needed.
Došlo je vreme za izbore u oblasti Unije.
The time had come for sort of notifications of the positions in the church.
Ja sam iskreno molio Boga, pošto sam bio i predavač na fakultetu teološkom.
Predavač?
Lecturer.
Oh, okay.
Predavač.
He was a lecturer at a theological school at
da,
the time.
Da, braća odgovorna mi dodele da budem full-time profesor, da se malo odmorim jer sam bio previše umoran.
Well, the guys, the professors and the leaders of the university were appointing him to be a full-time lecturer.
Dakle, gde sam bio? Imao sam problem.
Where was I? I had a problem.
Nisam znao šta dalje.
I didn't know where to go next.
Zamišljao sam rešenje tako.
I was thinking of outcomes in my head.
I prošli su izbori.
And the elections had finished.
Svi su pastori dobijali pozicije i svi ostali koji su dobili su poziciju.
All the ministers had received their positions and their notations.
Fakultet je popunjen.
The faculty was full.
Malo sam se nadao da jedno mesto kuvarice je upražnjeno.
In a little place I noticed that the chef or the cook was
ali to je uskoro bilo popunjeno, tako da i tu više nije bilo mesta za mene.
The position of chef was taken, so that wasn't even a position for me that I could go in.
Pomislio sam, jel moguće da, ne znam.
I was wondering whether I could or I couldn't. I was lost. I wasn't in the right place. I didn't know.
Da li bi želeo da se pridružiš Adri, da budeš direktor Adre?
Would you like to join Adra and be a director of Adra?
Ja, inače, ako me znate, znate da ja nekad ne kažem ne, kažem pa hajde da razmislim.
As you probably know me, or the ones who do know me, I don't answer straight
out. Ali iskreno nisam pomislio, nisam čuo hor anđela koji kažu to je za tebe.
I didn't I can be honest with you, I didn't hear a choir of angels singing out there saying, oh, this is for you, you're going to be this.
Rekao sam možda.
I said maybe.
Otišao kući, razmišljao.
I went home and I thought about it.
Imao sam jednog Serafima kod kuće, gospođu Mitrović.
I had family and friends at home with me that were there for me.
Koja je rekla, mislim da si ti za to.
Who looked at me and said, I think your position is for that.
Ja sam se vratio tamo i rekao da.
I returned back to the faculty or the university or whatever and said yes.
To the board, actually.
Or to the board of the.
Ali zapravo sam to uradio da ne bih ostao bez posla, iskreno.
But I did that, to be honest, just so I could keep a job, because I didn't have a job at the time, so I took on the position.
Tako da ponekad dođe situacija u kojoj i kad napravite korak u tom smeru, on nije onako za udžbenike primjer samouverenog da. To nije uvek. Da, nije uvek samouvereno da.
Yep. Sometimes the decisions that we make or the directions that we're supposed to go in don't always come out with a clarity that is placed in front of your face and says, that's it, that's what you need to do.
Ali ako fast forward 12 godina sada napravite.
But if you fast forward your life 12 years to where you are now.
Moje iskustvo, šta je Bog sve radio grupi ljudi koji sam deo u Adri?
What God has done for me and the group of people that are together at
Adra. Ja nisam mogao da sanjam.
I couldn't even dream.
Dubinu radosti koju imam sada.
The depth of happiness and joy that I feel now.
U smislu misije za crkvu za Boga.
In the aspect of the mission of the church for God.
Da je sada kroz rad Adre u poslednjih 7-8 godina.
That the work now in the mission with Adra.
Ne samo što sam ja ispunjen, to je možda najmanje bitno.
Not just because of what I've done in the last period of time, but već that's not important.
Da je Adra i crkva su prepoznati u Srbiji.
That Adra and the church are now recognized in Serbia.
Kao lideri u najvažnijoj oblasti kojom se niko nije bavio sada.
That they're leaders in areas that no one has even gone into.
A to je oblast homelessness.
And that's the help of the homeless.
Koje je drugačije nego u zapadnom svetu, o tome ću govoriti u 4 sata danas.
I'll talk about that more in this afternoon session about that.
Svi broadcasteri od nacionalnih preko međunarodnih pričaju o crkvi i Adri u Srbiji.
All the broadcasters and all the televisions, broadcasting agencies, talk about the association of Adra and the church
iskreno,
in Belgrade.
Pominjem crkvu, zapravo je mnogo bitnije da o Hristu, o hrišćanski kontekst, o Bogu se priča na drugačiji način.
More importantly is to refer the whole aspect to Christ and
ni
sanjao
nisam mogao.
But we're basically thinking about more of the aspect.
I što je najzanimljivije, Bog spaja dve velike struje sada u našim krajevima. Govorim čak i o Hrvatskoj i Srbiji.
What's most important right now is God's connecting two important channels together both in Serbia and in Croatia.
COVID je doneo veliku popularnost za nekoliko YouTube kanala. To znate već, vjerovatno.
During the period of COVID, that brought a lot of interest and a lot of popularity to a few channels on YouTube.
Stotine hiljada pregleda ljudi iz naših krajeva koji gledaju naše pastore, slušaju naše pastore i gledaju.
Over 100,000 watchers or viewers watching our pastors on YouTube.
I što se nikad nije dogodilo u mom iskustvu, dolaze mladi ljudi u crkve u našim krajevima u prethodne dve godine. Novi ljudi.
What's interesting is through that process, young people have been coming to the church in the last, two years?
Da.
Have been coming into the church due to the fact of these videos and missions.
I to mladi muškarci, što je uvijek bilo neobično. Mladi muškarci, 18 do 25 godina, vrlo retko.
And what's really unusual about it is that the congregation that's coming into the church is young men who are more prominent coming in at the moment.
Prepreka koju oni imaju, to je još uvek predrasude njihovih porodica i njihovih gradova, njihovih sela.
They're ones who are sort of pretty much coming from those little villages and little towns.
Koje su snažne, nisu kao što su nekad bile, ali su još uvek snažne predrasude.
These are places which are quite prominent and quite knowledgeable and known amongst the people around there.
Sinoć sam pominjao, ima 6,500 adventista krštenih u našoj uniji, koja je četiri zemlje. 6,500.
There's 6,500 members that are part of your union, is that right? Mm-hmm. The union of churches there. Yeah.
Što je jedan adventista na 1,000 ljudi u Srbiji.
There's one Adventist amongst 1,000
Serbs. Ali na popisu sada, koji je bio pre par mjeseci, na popisu, na census.
Yeah, on the last census that was just done.
30 i više hiljada ljudi je napisalo Adventista.
But there's been an addition of an extra 30,000
za nas
people
to su ogromne
brojke. Adventists. That's an unusual group of
people. I shvatili smo zajedno the bottleneck, usko grlo.
Yep. They realized that the bottleneck would work.
Je kako da oni dobiju neku vrstu podrške da pripadnu zajednici ako se odluče za našu zajednicu. Kako da dobiju, kako da im se pomogne da postanu deo zajednice.
The aspect of it was to how to guide these people into becoming united together in the actual purpose of the
church. I ono što gledamo, to je da ova polako reputacija koja se dizala.
And watching this on how this reputation was slowly growing.
Adre i crkve je upravo ta podrška.
Adra and the church literally the ones that are sort of forming it and creating it.
Za naše krajeve to je još uvijek jako važno da taj javna slika, public image bude tačniji, a ne onako pun predrasuda.
The thing that's important here is that the message and the vision that people see is coming from the church and it's most prominent and that seems to be the one that's moving.
Slika od crkvi se menja.
Yeah, the picture of the church.
Kada mladi dođu, ove nove generacije kojima ja pripadam.
When the young come to the church, the ones that I belong to.
Oni vole istinu, ali vole crkvu koja je aktivna u zajednici.
They love the truth, but they also love a church that is active in the truth.
I ne samo da hrani siromašne.
Not only just to feed the
nego da se udružimo.
The homeless, but to unite with them and to get together with
them
and share with them.
I da zajedno predlažemo vlastima neka rješenja.
To share with them ideas,
advocacy.
Yeah,
to je engleska reč, advocacy.
Yeah, advocacy. Yeah.
Da dignemo glas i damo pametna rješenja, da budemo uporni u tome. I to se dešava u Srbiji.
Yeah, to raise our voices and to become prominent in that area, to show people the importance of the mission that is at hand.
Više o tome u 4.
That's going to be more about that at 4 o'clock today.
ali ovo je sad služilo kao ilustracija za ovo. Ali ovo što sam pričao je bila ilustracija za ovo.
But what I've been talking about was an example of what we've been seeing on the screen.
Kada je Bog zvao? Seti se. Kad te je Bog zvao prošli put?
Remember when God called you last time.
Nije bilo lako.
It wasn't easy.
Ali kad si odgovorio pozitivno.
But when you answered positively.
Nakon toga garantujem, nikad nisi zažalio.
I can guarantee you, you will not, and you wouldn't regret what you did.
Poslušala si, poslušao si.
You listened and you obeyed.
I oživeo.
And you came to life.
Zar nije bilo tako?
Wasn't it like that?
Uvek.
Always.
Ja uvek kad pričam svojoj deci.
I always when I speak to my children.
Uvek nikad nisam isključiv. Dakle, nikad ne kažem. Nikada ili uvek. Okay. I avoid these words.
Okay. All right. No. When I speak to my children, I never use the words never or no or things like that. I usually.
Ali kad ih gledam u oči i kad im govorim o životu.
But when I look at them in the eyes and I'm telling them about life.
Jedino gde iskreno vam kažem nikad.
I have to tell you honestly, I never.
Je kad god sam smogao snage da odgovorim na Boži poziv u nekoj intimnoj oblasti mog života.
Whenever I've been able to explain my life and the callings that I've received that have been intimate with me,
nije bilo lako.
It wasn't easy.
Ali se nikad nisam pokajao.
But I never regretted it.
Porastao sam.
I grew older and wiser.
Nikad ne zaboravite to.
Never forget that.
Nikad ne zaboravimo to.
Don't ever forget that.
Jer where next? Kuda sad?
The question is, if you don't forget that, the question that's coming to your mind is, where next?
Je pitanje koje visi nada mnom i nad tobom.
That's a question that is placed upon not only us, but yourselves as well, every individual one of you.
Možda za tvoje, uvezano za tvoje zdravlje.
Maybe it's associated with your health.
Tvoju supružnika, porodicu.
Maybe your family or your wife.
Tvoju službu, misiju,
your duty, your service,
tvoju profesiju,
your profession.
I ovo pitanje visi nad ovom crkvom u ovom kraju sveta.
And this question hangs on this church in this part of the world.
Bog će ti uputiti ili možda već upućuje poziv.
God will either give you a calling or he may not give you a calling.
I nemoj da te zbuni osjećaj.
And don't let your feelings interfere with your decision.
Nelagode, discomfort.
Yeah, don't let discomfort.
Ili strah.
Or fear.
Te navedu na odgovor negativan.
To take you on a decision that becomes negative.
Prošli put kad si poslušao.
Last time when you listened.
Nikad se nisi pokajao.
You didn't regret it one little bit.
I molim Boga da nam prvo da jasno šta nas poziva da uradimo?
I ask first that God gives us clearly a message of what he wants us to do next.
A da onda prihvatimo.
But then for us to actually accept that.
Amen.
Amen.
Hvala bratu Igoru na poruci koju je podelio sa nama i savete koje nam je uputio.
Thank you brother Igor for the message that you brought us today and for the advice that you have given us.
I evo mi smo došli do kraja, da kažem, prvog dela bogosluženja.
And to say we've come now to the end of our first part of our service today.
I završit ćemo ovo bogosluženje sa zajedničkom pesmom i molitvom brata Igora.
And we're going to finish off this part of the service with a song and a prayer by our brother Igor.
Ima nas ovde, ja da kažem, puno.
There's many of us here today.
I stoga očekuje se da pesma se ori, pošto nas ima puno, logično je da se ori pesma i svakog roda.
And we would expect that because there's many of us here today, that the song that we sing it with gladness and joy and strength and power.
Znam da ste umorni, ali otpevajmo pesmu živo iz grla i iz srca našeg.
We know that we're a bit tired, but please sing with a joyous heart and give it all you've got. Amen.
Understand that so far we reached this point guided by your ambition out of your pure love for us to be all that we can become through you. And yes, Lord, we can say now we don't have a reason not to accept the next call, wherever it may lead us to, because we know it will be in your providence the best possible spot where our deepest gladness meets one of this world's deepest needs. We pray that this becomes true for each of us and for this community, this church community, and the church communities we belong to. Thank you for your providence and love that surpasses our knowledge and expectations. In Jesus' name, amen.
Čekate još samo jedan minut, dva da iznesem obaveštenja koje imamo danas vezano i za ručak koji je sada, koji sledi, a i za dalji program.
If I could ask every one of you just to please hold on for a moment as we give you a few more announcements before we all go to the hall for lunch.
Ručak imamo u ovoj našoj sali ovde koja je pored ove zgrade.
Lunch we're having in the hall which is at the back here next to the church.
I kogod želi može doći na ručak.
And whoever wants to come for lunch is more than welcome.
Red za ručak će biti u hodniku i biće tu redari koji će davati uputstva.
Lunch is set up in tables and everything, but you will be directed by the by the deacons in the hall.
Obaveštenje za one koji imaju posebnu ishranu.
For the ones who have a special diet,
koji su gluten free ili su ili alergični možda na neku bolest ili ne znam šta.
Those who might be
na neku hranu, izvinite.
Those who might be a gluten intolerant or they might be vegan. There's a special.
Nemaju potrebe uopšte da idu posebno da traže u kuhinju i da vide za njih šta ima, samo kad dođu na red da uzmu hranu, samo neka kažu njihov zahtev.
There's no need for you to go and ask anything at any place, but when you actually go to the order of picking up your food, please just mention to the person what your preferences
znači,
might be.
Znači ima za sve, mislim i za gluten free, i za alergične, i za sve. Znači samo kad dođete na red, recite vaš zahtev i to ćete dobiti.
Just to let you know, whatever your desires are, we've got it all covered. So just go up to the people or the deacons and the servers and ask them for service with your food.
Kao što je pastor Igor već rekao, u 4 sata ćemo se ponovo sastati ovde i slušat ćemo iskustva koje će onda podeli sa nama.
As we've heard from Pastor Igor, we're going to hear some more experiences and more of the message at 4 o'clock this afternoon.
I nastavljamo znači dalje popodnevni deo bogosluženja i popodnevni program imamo.
And we're continuing with our afternoon service and the program that is to follow it.
Pozivaju se svi kogod može i želi i hoće sutra da dođe na izlet u Bring Bang Parku.
There's an invitation to whoever wants to come. That's tomorrow to come down to Bring Bang Park.
Sastanak tamo je u 11 sati.
The meeting at Bring Bang Park will be at 11 o'clock.
Mesto gde se, pošto je Bring Bang Park veliki, mesto gde se sastajemo zove se Parking C.
Bring Bang Park is actually quite a big area, so the area where everyone's going to be joined together or coming together or meeting is called Parking Area C.
Oni koji se služe tehnologijom imaju na ulaz sa strane QR kod na koji kada ga koriste on će da ih odvede na to mesto.
There are people who are technologically minded and want to follow it through their app. They can actually go and QR code the actual meeting place outside the,
znači,
in the foyer.
Lokacija i QR kod se tu.
Yeah, it gives you the location through that QR code.
Ponesite šta vam treba, znači da sednete, ponesite možda šešire za ako je sunce jako. Šta god mislite da vam je potrebno, ponesite sa sobom.
Please bring any amenities that you might need with yourself, whether it's a chair or whether it's a hat or something, because those things will not be provided. You need to bring
naravno hranu ponesite sa sobom.
And also, naturally, bring your own food.
Toliko sam imao od obaveštenja i evo Igor će samo još završiti sa poslednjim.
That was all I had in the notices and notifications, so I'm finished with that.
Popodne zvanično počinje u 5.
This afternoon, it truly begins at 5 o'clock, is that right?
Tako je. Yep. Ali ovo u 4 nije obavezno, mislim ništa nije obavezno, ali ovo u 4 je onako neoficijalno.
The coming at 4 o'clock, there's a 4 o'clock and a 5 o'clock. The 5 o'clock is the more important one, the 4 o'clock is not necessary, but you're more than welcome to come and partake.
More than welcome i ja bih snažno preporučio da dođete. Biće zanimljivo i biće interaktivno.
I'd highly recommend that you come at the 4 o'clock one because it's going to be interactive and highly interesting.
Tako da dođete.
Please come for that.
Izvolite sada svi na ručak.
Okay. Please make your way to lunch.